The views and opinions expressed on any program are those of the persons appearing on the program and do not necessarily reflect the views and opinions of the New Media Factory. Some programs on this network might include strong images and language and may not be suitable for all audiences. Viewer discretion is advised.
Just when I thought I was out, they pulled me back in.
The biggest, most outrageous online show in Philippine history.
20 million fucking downloads.
Interactive in 35 countries. Mo is back with a vengeance in season 2. Bigger, better, badder.
Let's start off with an international call. Yesterday we took a call from India. Tonight it's Canada.
Nice.
Let's go to Ireland. Where in Ireland are you?
Well, I'm in Dublin.
Some people say that I'm a bad guy. They may be right.
Let's go to Afghanistan. Holy shit, are you fucking really in Afghanistan?
Yeah, man, what's up?
Florida, what's up?
I just found your show today, and I think it's great.
Live from Hollywood and at the Beyond the Box Studios in One Rockwell, Makati, it's Good Times with Mo, the podcast, season 2, the bigger, better, badder podcast. Your questions about love, life, sex,
and more sex
are all answered and occasionally made fun of here. And now, the man who loves women and dudes, but not in the same way, the Philippine genius, DJ Mo Twister.
Bit of a late entry there. Welcome to the podcast on a Friday night. It is the last day of May, payday, and I am glad that you guys have made your way here on the program. It is Good Times for Mo, the podcast season 2, brought to you by Globe. My name is Mo, phone number 478-7954. You can catch us on Skype, the Good Times Podcast. Text is 0927-360-0485. On the show tonight, a co-host of mine from the old radio show, who, as some of you know, I guess, did you get fired or did you resign, Chopper, after your fight with Grace?
I think Grace Lee fired me, but I resigned.
You got fired. You know, people get fired, never get fired. They get resigned. If you're in public, I resign. You rarely ever kind of just get fired. But, you know, it was not because you weren't a good DJ. You were a great DJ. Oh, Angelicopter. I'm sorry. I didn't even introduce you. Hi, Angelicopter. How are you? Nice seeing you again.
Nice.
I saw you over the weekend. I invited Chopper here to my niece's 30-year-old birthday party. And I know you have a 3-year-old. And
yeah.
So you were in town. You're in Los Angeles.
Mm-hmm.
I invited you to come over. It's nice seeing you again. Now, what are you doing now? Like, okay, so after radio, you are now trying your luck in showbiz in the U.S. I know you jump from city to city. If not,
yeah,
in,
I'm looking for like a sponsor, trying to join reality shows here and all those kind of stuff. No.
No, but you work IT now, right? And you
yes.
travel a lot, you know, like all
yes.
over the U.S. and shit.
Yes.
It's
a boring if I start talking
okay,
about
fine.
It.
Never mind.
Yeah,
but you just do an IT.
For Microsoft. Yeah, I'm marketing for IT, but it's
nice.
It's really nice.
Cool. Well, it's nice to hear your voice back on the radio, kind of, since it's not really the radio. It's a podcast. But
I know.
Again, Angelicopter on the show tonight. We've got a lot of love questions, sex advice questions, career stuff. Chopper, you are familiar with the podcast. You were here a couple times during season 1, so you know how it works. Are you ready to go?
Yes, I'm ready.
Let's do it. Angelicopter on the program tonight on a payday. By the way, we hear that there's some sort of like a apartment or condo fucking exploded in Surendra a little while ago. So if you are in that area, please be safe. But a friend of mine, you know, Tria, she tweeted a very Fight Club Ang Peg exploding apartment. Jeez. I hope it's not some sort of terror shit, but yeah, be safe, everyone. All right, let's get to it. We got calls to take, people to talk to. Remember, every single person that calls the show and gets on the air wins 3 movies from clickplay.ph. Plus, you get that chance at the iPad mini, obviously courtesy of Globe. Let's start with Mark. Mark, you're 24 in Padakan. Mark, welcome to the program. Thanks for holding, by the way, for a little bit.
Yeah,
what's up?
Hello.
How can we help you?
Hello, yeah.
Hello,
yeah,
Mark.
Really
go.
Robotic, but...
Oh, do
Hello?
I? Yeah, I hear you fine.
Yeah.
Go.
Yeah, I'm hearing you fine as well now. Okay, hello, Angelica.
Hi, good evening.
What's up?
Hi, good evening.
Chopper, just like you were on the radio, your fucking phone down.
I'm supposed
in the
to be working right now.
Why don't you just put it down? All right. What's up, Mark?
Yeah, what's up? Yeah, regarding my questions, like what I said earlier, yeah, you know, since last year, December, we're together. And then, you know, every day, every night, yeah, every night we're having sex. So, a question, is it bad for my dick, even in menstruation with, you know,
is it? Yeah, Chopper, this is how it works. You haven't been on radio for a while, huh?
I know. Yeah.
Chopper just starts laughing. I'm like, oh, this is nothing. This is a normal question, no problem. Is having sex every day, even on her menstruation, is that bad for your dick, is your question? Yes?
Yeah. Yeah. That's my question.
It depends on if your dick hurts. Like, no, really. Pain is the great indicator, as we always say on the show. If you're... No, I mean, listen, your dick is fine. It'll be fine unless it starts to bleed, like the skin starts to get irritated because of all the friction, or it's painful. Like, excuse me, it just hurts. I mean, it also depends on kind of like what position you're in. If you're in like high impact, deep impact, but
position.
Yeah, some guy called the show once a few weeks ago. He's like, "Gusto ko talaga malaman kung anong position para sa deep impact." Deep impact. If it's volatile sex and it's every single day and all of that, then I mean, yeah, it can get your dick hurt, but you'll know it'll be bad for your dick when your dick in fact shows signs of it being damaged.
It's just gonna be a lot darker than most guys' dicks.
That's
because
true.
You're gonna use it more often. Than
that's
the others.
Oh, Chopper, you fit right in on the show. How do you know that? Yeah, let me ask you. Your dick is pretty dark, right, compared to the rest of your body?
Yeah, somehow.
Yeah, it's because you use that dick a lot. You know. Like anything, I mean, you scratch your stomach, it's going to get dark. You scratch your arm, your elbows get dark. So you, if you're already a dark guy, man, you have black dick.
Oh, my God.
And what sucks is because, like, you have a black dick that's small. that's the problem, Mark. But, yeah, you'll be fine. You'll be fine. I mean, in her menstruation. No, yeah.
I know, wait. Kasi,
go.
You feel something bad from your heart. You know, different from normal.
The skin?
There's something rough inside.
I don't know. I'm not understanding him. You said the skin is kind of rough on your penis?
No, when you penetrate, parang you feel it's rough. And like...
Your skin or your partner's skin feels rough.
We can barely hear you, Mark. I don't know if it's your girlfriend's skin that's rough inside or yours. You guys, by the way, Mark, take a break, man. Fucking A, right?
Yeah, why does it have to be every day?
You guys have had sex for 6 months straight every fucking day. Maybe, you know, not that I'm not concerned about your dick, but I'm concerned about her vagina, too. I mean, she's the one who's taking, you know, a little bit of the pounding. She might want a day off, Mark. So put the dick down.
No.
You know.
She's the one who's actually in me.
Okay, how about this? Instead of, okay, on your day off from sex, instead of, like, having sex, why don't you go down on her
things.
Yeah, do different things. I mean, refrain from fingering her as well. Kind of go down on her, have a nice little 69 session, and call it a night. Give the dick a break, and give the vagina a break a little bit, okay, to recover.
Good. Yeah.
All right.
Good advice.
Of course, that's how you call the show.
Of course,
right?
It's great. It's genius. All right, Mark, thanks for the call. Have a good one.
Nice to have that.
Bye-bye. Yeah, this is most stellar genius advice. Why don't you take a day off? Oh, fantastic advice. That's fucking great, man.
Stop having sex for a while.
Yeah, no one would have ever said that to me. That's really smart. You're going to the top. Ikaw sisikat ka talaga mo. Galing.
Parang yung parokya ni Edgar.
Okay, Jinri Park. Let's take a next call and talk to Cherry. Cherry, you're on the show. What's up?
Hi, good evening.
Hi, Cherry. This is the Angelicopter on the program tonight. You're 19. Oh, no, you're not 19. Yeah, sorry, the other girl's 19. You're 21 and you're calling from Quezon City. What's up?
Yes.
Yes, go ahead. Cherry.
how can a person easily move on from a breakup?
How can a person move on from a breakup? God, the number. Okay, hold on 1 second. God, people's connections tonight not doing very well here on this Friday. How to move on from a breakup? This could be the. I wonder what's the most popular call we take here on the show. Maybe I can ask the staff. Ange, you've been here since season one. What's the most popular common question we take on this program? Is it how to move on from a breakup, or is it premature ejaculation? Is it what is it, Ange? You're the producer of the show. You should know. And you used to be call taker, so you were on the front lines here. You would know of anyone. And me, you know, I don't care about these people, so I would never remember. What's the number one most common question we get?
It might be a tie between premature ejaculation and that girl's question,
how to move on from a breakup.
Yep.
That and some sort of like, is it gay if I blow my friend? You know, it's...
Oh, my God.
There's always like... You know, listen, no, time out. There's a gay guy question has to be the most popular, right? If you come to think about it, I mean, the gay guy questions are the most popular. Mm-hmm. And which one of the gay guy questions have to be it?
If they're bisexual, they're not sure if they're bisexual.
Yeah, it's like that, right? Yeah, it's something like it has to always do something. Oh, no. How do I tell my parents I'm gay?
Oh, come out.
Yeah, that I think is the number one. Shit, I don't know, man. It's close. So it's how to move on from a breakup, how do I last longer in bed, and how do I tell my family and friends that I'm gay? Thanks, Ange. Appreciate it. Okay, so anyway, back to you, Cherry. Best way to get over a breakup. Gosh, we all deal with it so differently. That's the thing. But the one true thing that stands to be, like, accurate is time. The cliche, time heals, it's so... goddamn true. Now, some people it's a few weeks, some people it's a few months, some people it's a few years. It really is kind of, it depends on the person. But I think every person that breaks up eventually kind of looks back at it and laughs at how much pain they went through. And like, oh my God, I can't believe I was so weak. So how long has it been since you broke up?
I think it's been 3 years.
Oh.
Yes.
3 years. And how long were you guys together?
I think almost 11 months.
Oh.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Cherry, you're mourning a little too long, yeah. Love.
The mourning is longer than the relationship itself, so that's not good.
Yeah, you need to start getting involved with other people, I think. I mean, at this point, because what helps obviously is hanging out with your friends and you know, keeping yourself busy. That always helps. But since it's been 3 years and you've probably tried everything already, I suggest, Cherry, try getting into another relationship.
Yeah.
Because it's past the rebound stage now, I think. And maybe if you're inspired or if you see something, kind of go on a couple of dates and stuff like that. Really start just kind of reminding yourself that there are people out there that desire you and that this one guy wasn't the only one. And hopefully was. Now, he might always be the one that got away. Like 5 years from now, 10 years from now, you're still going to think about this guy that was fantastic. But at least you've got the ball rolling in terms of getting involved with other people. Okay?
She's still trying to get over him.
Hello? All right. Yeah, she's gone. Thank you, Cherry, for the call.
I have a follow-up question about that. I saw him again after maybe 2 years, and I don't feel anything after I saw him. Is that an indicator that I moved on already?
Yes, I thought that you called because you weren't moving on. That's awesome. If you saw him, you know, after 2 years and you don't feel anything, yes, you have in fact officially moved on. And how everyone says certified. You're certified. Move on. Okay.
Issue a diploma or something.
When I saw his profile that he's going to have a baby. Some kind of hurt on that in his the one
what
that
her grammar all of a sudden just getting with it. Earlier it was fine. All of a sudden just went to shit.
It must be an indicator.
What the fuck happened to you? I just swap phones and someone. Cherry, Yeah, okay, he might, again, like I said, be the one that got away, that when you see them officially finally getting married or something, you go, oh, shit.
This should have been me.
Yeah, oh, man, yeah, oh, they're having a baby. Fuck, yeah. You know, but you're going to be fine. Trust me, you're already fine. You saw him after 2 years, you didn't feel anything. You found out he was getting married. Of course, it's normal to go shit, but what are you going to do? You're gonna be just fine. Thanks for the call. Appreciate it. Bye bye.
Thank you.
Woo. Chris, 24, line 4. You're on the program. We got a lot of calls tonight, by the way, Chopper.
That's good.
Chris, 24. What's up?
Hello, Mo.
Hi, Chris. You've been on hold for a while. How can we help you?
Yeah, it's okay. I have a question. I have an ex. I've known him for like 6 years. And we've been together for like 4 years. And
okay.
The reason why we broke up is he's a womanizer. And then just recently, we went clubbing with my sister. Cause we're friends after everything, and but I'm totally moved on because it's been like 3 years ago, and I know that he's been hitting a lot of girls before, so I'm really okay. And what happened was, while we're clubbing, he went out of the club with my sister's best friend without. Saying, hey, we're just gonna go out. Like,
Chris, I'm sorry, I'm so lost. Chris, sorry, love.
Yes.
I'm completely lost. I'm trying my best here to hold on to what the story is. Just get basically, what are you trying to ask? Don't worry about whose friend, whose sisters. What do you want to know?
I felt that I was disrespected because I'm with my sister and my some of our childhood friends, and I felt that
you felt disrespected. Why?
No, listen.
Obviously, you sound actually nervous right now. You're very nervous, but Chris, let's relax a little bit. Okay.
Okay.
So you went out. You went out to a club with your sister and your friends, and you saw your ex-boyfriend. And you feel disrespected because he had another girl, and he was what, making out with her in front of you, or? What?
Yeah, and then they went out without even saying, "Hey, we're just gonna go out."
But you broke it up, right?
Kahit sa sister ko. And then they're all like, "Nasaan na sila?" Ganyan. So I don't know. And then
Chris,
like in the middle of the night, he vibered me, and then he said. They're nasa house sila. Like, what?
Chris, who gives a shit if they don't say goodbye to you? They don't have to say goodbye to you. It's not disrespectful.
No, not to me. Like, to our... Even to my sister.
They don't have to.
Even more.
What if they were horny and they just wanted to go to the bathroom and fuck a little bit? They're not gonna... Paano bang papaalam pa sila?
Wait lang.
Mangangantot lang kami dun.
Got a boner here.
I just feel disrespected. Like,
no, you feel embarrassed or ashamed that he's with another girl in front of your sister and your friends, and you're not over him, and he's showing everyone that he's over you, or whatever it is that. I
agree with Chopper here. I don't think you're disrespected because they said goodbye. I think it was an awkward situation where. You're with your sister and he's with a new girl. I mean, like, it shows like, hey, look who's moved on. Look
exactly.
Who's won. Look who's, you know, it's like, and you feel bad about it. And now you're just dissecting every little piece of misstep they do or miscommunication. And then you're going to go, okay, now that's disrespectful.
It's not.
I mean, you happen to find yourself in an area where you saw an ex-boyfriend who had a new girlfriend.
But if that night you were with another guy... And he was with another girl. You wouldn't feel disrespected.
You wouldn't feel
You're probably strutting your way and showing him, yeah, look at me. I'm with a guy who's hotter than you. You'd be thinking that way. But it just so happened that night you were with your girlfriends and your sister, and he was with another girl.
Chris, I understand you have feelings, and I know your feelings are hurt, and I know all of these things. But I will tell you right now, black and white, the guy didn't do anything wrong. He doesn't have to make pa'alam. Actually, in fact, I am the... one of the kings of leaving an area without saying goodbye. I mm-hmm. will just leave. I don't like saying goodbye. I don't like saying hello. I just if I'm at a place and I see my friends, I'd rather actually leave without saying goodbye because they're gonna no stay. I'm like, I don't want that shit, man. I would rather just quietly leave the area and not be heard of. It's not disrespectful. Unless you're at someone's house, you know, like he came over your house and then just took off. But even I would do that. I would just leave. I don't want to say goodbye. It's not disrespectful.
Okay, sometimes Chris? I feel that I want to do revenge, you know.
Listen, you know me, baby. I'm all about revenge. I'll promote revenge. Be revengeful. Be vengeful. Vindictive. Yeah, whatever you want. But he hasn't earned it here.
He cheated on me like so many times, but we remained friends because I know that he doesn't have any friends, just me. Because I've known him for so long, even, you know. So I still gave him a chance to be friends. But for me, this is... No, for me... Yeah.
Chris, relax. Listen, what he did at the club is not worthy of revenge. However, if he did in fact cheat on you, then maybe one day, if you're his only friend and he needs you, guess what? Don't be there for him. And that's the nice, sweet revenge.
Yeah.
Okay? You're fine. You're
so
fine.
That's the best
Thanks
revenge.
For the call. Yeah, could be like you said, you know him. He doesn't have any friends. So, you know, it's just you. Okay, well, wait till he really needs somebody. And when he's there, don't
help
him.
There.
Yeah, don't be there for him. That'll be your nice revenge. Okay? And then you said, you should have said goodbye to me that one night. Fuck you. And then, you know, leave him on his own. Thank you, Chris. You're the best.
Have a good one.
Thank you, love. Friday night on the show, Angelicopter is here. It's good times for more of the podcast season two. Don't go away.
Stay tuned. We'll return after this commercial break.
We're always on the move. It's really important for us to get better and stronger for every competition that we get into. For all the different lifestyles that we have, some of us are graphic artists, filmmakers, we still find ways to get together. We put a lot of effort in practicing and rehearsing. Minsan may mga biglaang shows or auditions, so it's really important for us to get connected. I use my Globe group messaging to get a hold of everybody else. Malayo na rin ang narating namin, marami na rin kaming napuntahan. So it's really important to get connected.
Take a little sunshine, grab a little rainbow, mix in a smile, stay for a while. Sabrina's Kitchen, what you waiting for? Sabrina's Kitchen, always room for one more. Sabrina's Kitchen, cooking up a storm. Sabrina's Kitchen, always something new.
Hey, podcasters, Mo here. You ever watch the podcast, right? And you're sitting there and you're looking at our female celebrity guest and you're looking at her skin and you're like, wow, I'd love to have that complexion. Well, your answer is this. Glutamax, the official skin whitening partner of Miss Earth International. Available in capsules, soaps, lotion, deodorant, and face cream. Bikutis Mayaman with Glutamax. It's available in leading drugstores and supermarkets nationwide. Podcasters, listen up. Big announcement. The Chevrolet Sonic is a dependable 5-seater subcompact vehicle, and it delivers sufficient power, fuel efficiency, refined ride and handling, and a remarkable entertainment system. The Sonic is the perfect Chevrolet vehicle for those who are looking to make their daily city commute or weekend getaway drives more fun and exciting. It comes in two great body styles, the 5-door hatchback and a 4-door sedan. Equipped with a new 1.4-liter Ecotec engine with double continuous variable cam phase, that's CVC, the Chevy Sonic provides efficient power and quality driving performance. Now, to further highlight the youthful, sporty, and fun characteristics of the Sonic, Chevrolet has equipped the compact sedan with high-tech convenient features such as Bluetooth connectivity and audio streaming capabilities that are commonly found only on high-trim compact sedans. The Chevrolet Sonic is available at all Chevrolet dealers. It comes with a Chevrolet 5-year warranty, 3-year free roadside assistance, and the services of a 24/7 Chevy hotline.
With a game Chubby Bunny, but
have you played
Chubby Bunny before?
No.
You put a marshmallow in your mouth. You say Chubby Bunny. And you keep putting it in your mouth. You keep saying Chubby Bunny.
Okay.
Whoever can fit the most in their mouth wins. But we're not gonna say Chubby Bunny. We're gonna have a conversation.
Okay.
Perfect.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna ask you, okay ka na ba?
Okay.
And you're gonna be like, okay na.
Okay.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah.
Go.
Two at a time.
Okay. I'm gonna do two at a time. Okay, kind of what?
Okay, no, okay, no. I just saw it.
Okay, kind of what?
Okay, no, okay, no.
Okay, kind of what?
Okay, no, okay, no.
Okay.
My girlfriend says she hates me.
It's Good Times with Mo, the podcast. Call the show tonight and get your love problem answered.
Follow us on Twitter at GTWM Podcast.
And visit www.motwister.com.
Back on the podcast on this Friday night. It is the 31st of May. You're listening to Good Times with Mo, the podcast, season 2, brought to you by Globe. This here is Angelicopter. You can follow her on Twitter, The Angelicopter. And for someone in the private sector now, Chopper, no longer in the limelight. I mean, you were in Survivor. You were on the radio show. You did a little sports TV for TV5. Now in the corporate world, traveling the U.S. and doing all this crazy shit, you still have a lot of followers, huh, on Twitter. I mean, 40,000 is pretty strong for...
Yeah, they like my boring, vain, whatever humor... You got on Twitter.
Oh no, the vanity. I see you. I see you on Instagram with your side pose and you're just
because it makes me look.
It is no, it doesn't. I'm not telling you. No, listen. I
have double chin.
I would rather see. Okay, here this is the sakit ng girls who are 8s and 9s. they want to be perfect. Okay, fine. You're not perfect. You got a big fucking forehead. You have a double chin. But I'm telling you, when you guys are posting on Instagram, you don't see Ann Curtis or Georgina, the 10s, fuck around with angles and they just stand there straight up. It's the girls who are trying to get to that point with the same pose and the same this. Come on, man. Be comfortable in yourself. I saw a photo the other day of you, side face. Like, dude, just
said the guy who would always point out my forehead and double chin.
Because I want you to be comfortable with your flaws. It is a slight flaw. You're very attractive. No one has ever called you ugly in your life. You're fine. But you know, listen, relax with the pictures, man.
Okay,
you get the same fucking pose all the time.
All right, so I'd rather post Lucas's photos now because he's so cute, and thank you for taking his photos.
Yes.
By the way,
yeah, very cute kid. All right, anyway, here we go. To the phones. Phone number 478-7954. Skype the Good Times Podcast. Text is 0927-360-0485. Let's talk to Chloe, 19 years old. And in the dreaded part of the country called Cebu, I say dreaded because the people over there are fucking horny and sexually charged and crazy. And Chloe is no different. Hi, Chloe. You're 19.
Yes.
What's up, baby?
Hello, Mo. And hi, Angelicopter.
Hi, Chloe.
Yes. Yeah.
All right, crazy.
So about my problem, I called here like a few months ago and, I was telling you guys about, my sexual frustration and stuff. And just earlier, I made out with a good friend of mine. She's a girl.
Boy or girl? Yeah.
And, yeah. Yeah, I'm a girl. And,
Bow wow.
And so, I'm very lightweight, so I just, drank a glass of something that she made. It's mixed up and stuff. And because we made a deal. I told her that I would drink that glass even though I'm not even though I don't want to, but I would drink it if she would make out with me. And then, yeah, she said yes.
So you said
yeah, we did. And
Cebu.
Yeah.
Continue. Yes.
Sorry.
I love it. So, continue.
So at first I was just joking, but then she was like, yeah, okay. So I could be your first kiss and stuff. Well, she is now, technically.
Yeah.
And so we went to my friend's room because we were in her condo, another friend of ours. And so, yeah, we locked the door and we made out. And then I thought it was just going to be like a simple making out, but it went farther than that. We got to the third base. So
she had your excuse me. Third, what's the third base for you new kids? She had her tongue in your vagina?
Kitties. Pardon?
I'm sorry? Oh, she was sucking on your tits?
Isn't that
I actually got her off by yeah.
You finger blasted her?
Fingering her.
Oh, so awkward.
Double clicking the mouse is what we would use to radio.
Yeah, Star Wars shit. I mean, Star Trek.
All right. Sorry.
By the way, according to producer Ange, who is what we call a seasonal lesbian, she said, you know, seasonal, like minsan seasonal lang dragon fruit and, you know, lanzones, you know, santol. She said a fourth base or home run is finger blasting another girl. That's
what?
Home run. Yeah, well, of course, because you're talking vaginal penetration. I can see that. I thought, like, some sort of oral sex would be the home run, and finger blasting is third base.
Yeah.
But whatever. You guys
no,
are the, you guys define
oral
whatever
sex
it is.
Is the home run. Lesbians
yeah, that,
have five
yeah, because getting
yes,
off, right?
But there's only four bases. You can't say that
no,
oral sure. sex is the fifth base because walang fifth base.
Oh, nga, baseball.
That's
ano
what
ba?
My lesbian friend said.
Your lesbian retard friend has got an hour. There's only four bases. There's first base, second base, third base, and home run. There's no fourth base. Or unless you want to say that fourth base is in fact
it's
the home
run.
So what's first base? First base is making out. Second base is what? Grabbing some tits.
Yes.
Third base is fingering and home run or first or fourth is would be
going
oral
downtown,
sex,
yeah.
Right? For lesbians. Mm-hmm. Would that
but
be right?
It's different
then?
Touching
May
the clitoris is different from, you know, finger blasting or putting the finger
base.
Inside.
That's bullshit. If you're touching the clitoris, it's in the same base as finger blasting her. Listen, the bases are not the moves. It's not sexual moves. It's how, which parts of the body are you attacking? Like,
yeah.
If I'm first yeah, base, I'm making out, so it's lips to lips, right?
Exactly.
Second base is anything involving tits. Third base is hand down the pants.
Yes.
Fourth base is dick inside you. Now, if you're talking about lesbians, then we would have to kind of alter it where first base is making out, second base is tits, third base is finger blasting, fourth base is oral sex. Or you can go oral sex on third base and then finger blasting on home run. But that's how it has to be. Tell your lesbian friends to fix themselves.
I'm not lesbian, okay?
No. I'm talking about our producer, Ange, who's a seasonal lesbian. All right.
Okay.
Okay, Chloe, so back to you, love. So where were you? You
yes.
Finger blasted her. So let's just say that's a home run or third base,
yes.
Whatever it may be. What's your
okay.
question?
I'm sorry?
Yeah, what's your question? What's your question?
Oh, yeah. My question is because now, like, after everything, like, I mean, I got her off. But when I was, like, you know, while we were doing it, I actually, like, felt nothing. I was, like, I felt like I was on autopilot. Like, I didn't even enjoy it. Is
when
that normal?
When you were doing it, who was the giver and the receiver? Or was it your turn and she was... Oh, my gosh.
I don't know.
I don't think you enjoyed it because I don't think you're lesbian.
Yeah.
I think you just said, okay, I'm going to get drunk and do something stupid and I'm going to give it a shot. And when you gave it a shot, you realize it's not your thing. You do like guys, right? You like when guys finger blast you and have sex with you and do all that, right?
I've never done it with guys.
This was
so
her
she's
first
my first.
Yeah.
You mean
everything.
This is your first sexual anything?
That sucks.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
And you're not lesbian and your first was a girl?
Yeah. I know. Oh, it sucks. I'm a slut. It's crazy.
No, you're so far from a slut.
You're not.
Well, okay.
You're 19.
But are you a big masturbator?
Do you touch your
Yes, I am.
All right. Okay, fine. All right, you're working your way up. Listen, do me a favor. Have sex with a guy soon.
Yeah.
Have sex with a guy soon. You're 19 anyway, so it's about time. Have sex with a guy soon.
Yeah.
And then start kind of.
Days.
Well, great. Go fuck someone on your on midnight sex. Of your birthday, and then try to assess what you like more. You know, and right now you're of course finding yourself and your sexual identity and all of these things. And sure, you tried out the girl. You said you didn't like it that much. That's probably because you're straight. Yeah. And you know, have sex with a guy. And if that floats your boat, then fantastic. Welcome to the adult life.
Yeah, because I was actually thinking the same thing, like. I feel like very uncomfortable and I didn't enjoy it like the whole time. I think like my eyes were open and I'm like, ugh. And so I'm thinking like maybe I should try it out with a guy, and I was like, maybe would this make me a slut? Just because I just try it with a guy?
No. You just want to reassure yourself of your sexual preference?
Yeah. No, you're fine. Listen, you're starting to get super horny these days, and you're just, you know, you went with the person closest to you that you trusted. That's actually, you know, I like this move. Chloe, I like this move because it's someone you trust. You know, it's a really good friend of yours. Someone you know that's not going to fuck you over. That's not going to fuck you and leave you the next day. That's
not going
to, you know, it's not going to screw you over. You instead of yourself, which you've been masturbating a lot, you went to the next level, which is, okay, I'm going to go with my best friend. Now that you've tried your best friend, when you get a little bit more sexual confidence and you're a little bit more comfortable about being naked with someone and all that, you know, date around and then fuck that guy and then, you know, really start the ball rolling.
Yeah.
Okay? You're fine, Chloe. Yes, you're going to do just fine.
Oh, my God. Yeah. Thank you, Lord.
I kind of do like this move because it is someone you trust. Imagine when we all think about the person, especially females, when you all think about the person you lost your virginity to, if you kind of think about it now, would you have wanted to lose your virginity with that person still when you think about it? A lot of the answers are no, especially with girls. It's like, nah, I wish I just could have given it to someone else. At least here, you never have to kind of think about it that way. You gave it to someone you trusted, you cared about, and who will be around for a very long time. So I like it. I like this move.
That's true.
I don't want the person to be around for a very long time because I'm going to see and regret. That's the person I lost my virginity to. She's still here.
Yeah, but she didn't really lose her virginity. Yeah, you know, she just kind of, you know. Yeah. How many fingers did you put in her?
What?
How many fingers?
Okay.
How many fingers did you put in?
Too much detail.
All right. That's not bad. Working your way up.
Yeah.
Two's not bad. Yeah. Try to get a handshake in there next time. All right. Try to get a handshake in.
Oh God!
or a fist bump.
No. One of those things. No.
Thanks for the call, baby doll. Appreciate it.
All right.
Bye bye. Thank you.
That's like going for Kobe right away when he should start with Jeremy Lin. You know.
Do girls care how many fingers are inside Chopper? Is it like something where it's like, wow, do me 3 fingers? You know? Wow,
no.
Fumo 4.
No.
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 Is there a comfortable amount? Like, once you start going 4, it's like, okay, listen, relax. This is not a, you know.
Too much. Exactly. If you want to put 4 in there, just put your dick in there.
That's right.
I think it's more of Ange, and you can jump in anytime if you like because of your experience. I think it's more of the style or the
Yeah, but when you're young, like this girl, when you're 19, it's not about style. It's not about tenderness.
Right.
It's about statistics. It's like 1 finger. 2 finger. Oh, 3. About loose to 4. You know, and then
about the left hand.
Yeah, it's like
that's too much.
I wonder if you guys care about how many fingers are in.
No, guys should just focus on the movement. Be gentle. Don't like go crazy or anything.
Fair enough.
Doesn't happen. If they're going crazy when you're going crazy down there with your hands, they're faking it.
Solid. Let's go to Deanden 25 line 2. Hi, Deanden. Well, welcome to the show. You're from Makati, and how can we help you?
I just have a question. I need your answer or advice as a guy. Does it really matter who makes more money in a relationship?
Sorry, Deanden, you're a guy? Is that what you're saying?
Yes.
Okay, I'm sorry. You have got one of those names plus the voices that can go either way. Well, does it really matter? It depends if you're old school. You know, like, I'm super not old school. Like, I'm traditional in a lot of things, but when it comes to relationships, not too old school. So if the girl was making a lot more money than me, just as long as she's okay with it too, like, we've sat down, we've talked about it, we said, hey, you got a great job, congratulations, you worked hard for it, and you deserve it. Like, you make the salary like an individual accolade, an individual achievement. But you guys are still together with your wife, your husband, or whatever it may be. You guys are still together enjoying it anyway. Because if it was flipped over and I was making more money and you were making less, guess what? We're still going to both enjoy it together. So if she ends up making more money than you, that's a personal achievement on her part that both of you are going to get to enjoy. Mm-hmm. So I see nothing wrong with a girl making, just as long as you work, you know, don't do that thing where, oh, wow, darling, laki nakita mo, sige, dito na lang ako sa bahay, you know, and stuff like that. Don't do that. Work as well, no matter how simple the job is.
Yes.
You could be working at Starbucks or whatever, and she could be out there doing like what Chopper does, corporate IT or whatever the fuck. You know, just as long as you put in an effort that you wake up and you go to work and you're productive, regardless of how much it makes, man, who cares who makes more?
You don't want to be a leech, you know, even if you're not a leech, you know? I mean, you don't want to be a free rider. And if, especially if you're married. Are you married or you're just together?
No, not yet.
Oh, not yet. Yeah, so...
Yeah, don't worry. Is there a large discrepancy in salary? Like, does she make considerably more than you do?
Yes.
Yeah? All right. Well, hey, listen, again, like I said, if I was in your situation, I would not care at all. I would congratulate her.
Exactly.
For and remind her that she, in fact, deserves a large salary because of the work she put in school and on the way to getting wherever she is.
I think that the problem is, like, when she invited me to go out for a date, I said no. I think it's more...
Sorry, she invited you, like, she invited you where?
To come out, to have a dinner outside.
No, no, hey, listen, if she's going to invite you and she's going to take you out... I don't know. Because, you know, like, I grew up, my best friend was a female growing up, if you guys know Donita Rose. And she had so much money when I was young, and she would take me out to dinner every single time, and she would pay every... And maybe that's where I kind of got used to... It's okay for a female to pay. Now, if you're my girlfriend, I would pay because I make a lot now. But if I would be very comfortable with her taking you out to dinner and she paying for it, because you have to start getting realistic. She makes a ton more money than you do. Maybe what you can do is she'll take you out to dinner. You cook for her at home. You know, you kind of reverse the roles a little bit. But just remember, you have to put in effort and you have to be productive. And it should be fine.
And you also, if you keep saying no to those invitations, if you keep turning them down, she's going to start feeling bad about the situation. You might end up not being together because she's going to start feeling
very good
uncomfortable.
Point. I agree.
So give her the... Yeah.
Hey, listen, she's making money. Go out there and fucking
That's
spend it.
That's a good problem.
Let's go out there and spend it, man. Yeah. If she wants to spend it, then spend it. Spend it with her.
And then make up for it in bed or something. Be great in bed. Be
Four
great
fingers.
At home. No. Just.
All right. All right.
All right.
One for every thousand that she spent on you. All right. Thanks for the call, buddy. Appreciate it. You'll be fine, Deanna.
Thank you.
Don't worry about it. Don't be old school, man. All right. Have a good
day. I want to say that guy, what's the name of the caller?
Deanna.
I want to say that he's probably good in bed. That's why she's also staying with her, with him. But
can't he just be a nice person?
No, plus that, apart from that, he obviously sounds nice, but I was going to say he doesn't sound like he's good in bed, though. So he's probably a really nice person.
He's a stallion. All right, let's go to James on the cell phone.
Hello.
James, what's up, buddy?
Hello.
James,
I'm
sorry.
In the helicopter.
James, you're 23. Right. You are in Batangas. What's up?
Yep.
Go.
Mm-hmm. Right. So, hello.
Yeah, go.
Hello. Yeah. Well, basically, I'm calling because I don't have anyone to talk to about this matter. And this is kind of funny and life-changing, you know? I don't know. So here's the thing. So this happened a month ago, and basically, this is like sort of an experiment. So
okay.
I tried searching for a gay dating site in the internet, and you know, tried to hook up with one just to see if, you know, I'm actually gay or not. Just an experiment.
Sure.
And
okay.
So basically, I met a guy. He's from Ateneo. He's 5'11", and I'm only 5'6". No.
Okay.
So when we met up, I don't know. He's sort of kind of a model. I don't know. something like that.
Sure.
So,
okay.
He's good looking.
Right. Yeah, good looking. Totally unexpected. So what happened was when we were about to do it, you know, I started to kind of kiss him. Started to kind of held his junk, you know.
And yeah. He kind of sort of touched his dick.
And he actually gave me a blowjob, right?
Sure.
So
kind of sort of.
And when we're about to do the anal action, you know, I called it a stop, basically.
Sure.
Because you know he was totally hard, and I was half hard. If
you were close,
something like that. But so. Yeah. I told him that I'm really not attracted to him and that maybe I'm not really gay.
No, you're gay.
You are.
I was very happy at that time. I was very happy. But at the same time, as of now, I'm really thinking if I'm going to tell about this to my friends, especially to my girlfriend, you know, this is kind of an experiment. Right there.
I feel like I'm watching it. That story is
interesting.
Good.
No, because, you know, every guy listening to the show right now, driving in their car at home, pare putang ina bakla yan, it's the first thing that came to my mind. And it's the first thing that every heterosexual guy right now, maybe even every gay guy right now is thinking, because we don't do what we, listen, James, we don't do what Chloe just did, who, from Cebu, who called right before you, which is experiment to find out if we're gay. We don't, us guys, we don't do that.
Yeah.
We don't go on a gay dating site and go, I think I'm going to try to find out if in fact I truly only like girls by putting my hand on another penis, making out with a guy from Ateneo, having him give me a blowjob, and then right before he sticks his ultra hard dick in my ass, go, nah, you know what? Maybe I'm not gay. We don't do that.
Yeah.
That's not part of our repertoire.
I totally disagree with that. You know,
what?
I thought that there might be a chance.
Can you pump up his volume here, guy? Sorry. Thanks. Go ahead.
I'm sorry?
You disagree because?
Yeah, I disagree because, you know, I think just the thought of doing it is actually gay. But, you know, when you're on that situation and you just found out that, no, it's really not going to happen because I'm not feeling anything, that's a confirmation that you're not. Because your body tells you
see,
that
that's
not,
why.
Right?
Okay, listen, James. I understand what you're saying. That's why I said most guys, or in fact all guys, right now in their car or whatever, are thinking you're fucking gay. That's the first thing. However, I am going to bend my rules a little bit and say,
right,
maybe you're not gay.
Maybe you're not gay. But what happened when he went down on you?
Okay, listen.
Did you finish?
Time out. No, don't worry about that part. Because right now that's irrelevant. The whether he finished or not is irrelevant. That's a pleasure question. This guy is asking regarding an orientation question. The moment he looked up on a gay site and met up with the guy and they shook hands, it's the same thing as him being blown and coming in the guy's mouth. Like, once you get to the part of looking him up and meeting up with him, that's already kind of like, that's already supposed to be just gay for us.
Yeah,
you're gay, dude.
Yeah.
However,
I understand. Mm-hmm.
Okay, however, the reason, and the staff just sent me a message. They said, every single person in the room right now says you're gay. I said you're gay. Chopper says you're gay. Everybody listening to the show says you're gay. However, now let me continue. I hear your voice, and my one true talent in life is to listen to your voice and to find out if you're genuinely, like, if you're just genuine and credible. Like, I am a great human lie detector test. And I actually believe that you're that one out of a million people that really believed that this was only, in fact, an experiment. Like, you're stupid enough to even try it. And when, because this is wild. Like, I've never thought about it. Like, I'm the very first guy to say another guy's super hot. Like, I'm like, puta, that guy's fucking good looking, man. That fucking Erwan Husov, if I was gay, I would fuck the shit out of that ass because he's so good looking. But I would never, ever, ever hug him because I know it ends there. You, for some weird reason, actually thought about making it an experiment. And I believe you. Yeah. I believe you, James. I actually believe you're not gay. I think you're stupid for trying. Not stupid in the sense that you're not intelligent, but stupid because you had to go that far to prove it to yourself.
Yeah. Just think about it in your head. Don't share it with anyone else, especially if you're actually really straight. Don't tell anyone.
Like, when you saw his hairy anus, you were like, okay, na talaga. Ito na. Ito confirm na. Hindi na talaga. Hindi na.
Hindi talaga bakla.
Hindi na bakla. Taya na, pangit pala. Pare, ang pangit pala ng anus ng boy. You, everybody listening to the show thinks I'm wrong. Everybody thinks you're gay. I, in fact, actually kind of believe you. I don't know why.
Right. Thanks.
I think I hear a genuine, like, an honesty in your voice.
One more thing why I did it. Because, you know,
do you disagree with me, Chopper?
You know, to an extent, I agree with you, but he said as an AL.
No. He's just kidding. The guy's from Batangas. He's trying to be social. There he's back.
Hello.
James.
Hello.
James, we hear you. Shut up.
Back.
Do you have any urge to do it again? To contact?
No,
do you
no.
when you look at guys, do you ever go, "Oy, guapo yan?"
No. I mean, after that, I mean, even though I see guys now, "Whoa, guapo yun na," whatever. No urge at all, you know.
I believe him, man. There's something in his voice, I'm telling you. What's the point?
I don't see any reason for you to lie or to kind of cover up. You're probably straight.
No,
but don't tell your girlfriend what you do.
Don't tell your girlfriend.
My gosh.
Babe, wala kasi nandun na.
Experiment lang talaga.
Babe, hindi. Okay. In fairness, babe. Matigas yung titi niya.
Ako hindi.
At malapit na talaga sa puwet ko. Pero hindi kang ginawa. baby, promise. Listen, like, hinawa ka na lang titi niya. I promise. That's it.
Mo, one more thing.
Yeah,
one more thing. As I was saying a while ago, so the reason why I did it, because diba, right now, maraming married guys who are being unloyal to their wife by having a gay relationship, right? Medyo
sure.
Na
sure.
Siya
That's
ngayon.
Because
and
they're gay.
I don't want that to happen to me, you know? If I'm gonna marry a woman, I would make sure that I'll be loyal to her until the end of my days. And I'll be sure that I am the right guy, and I'm a guy who married that girl. So maybe that is another reason why I did it.
Maybe. One of our staff members, and I don't know if this is Tugi or someone just using they sent me a message. They said, in fairness, in defense of you, a friend of mine searched a gay site for the same reason, to check if he's gay, but ended up vomiting on the keyboard. That's what's supposed to happen. It's supposed to stop there. I'm thrown by how far you went with it. Him giving you a blowjob and all of that stuff. And that's so, like, kissing him. Like, cause it should have ended there. The moment you kissed him, you should have gone, "Oh, no, this is not for me." But you ended up kissing him still and then putting your pants down and then allowing him to put your dick in his mouth. All of a sudden.
Yeah.
I don't know, man.
Well,
I think I'm changing my mind.
But the site that you went...
Hold on, Chopper. Go.
Yeah, just a few details of what happened. So it happened very, very quick in his place, okay? So I didn't do anything. I told him that I had no experience with that or whatsoever. So he did all the acts, right?
So
I was just, like, standing, something like that. So basically, everything happened so quick. And when on that anal moment, I totally just can't do it there.
He was going to put his dick in your ass?
No.
Or were you so good? Did he
to.
Want you? He
no.
want you. He wanted you to put your dick in his ass.
He wanted to. I mean.
No. Time out. He wanted your ass, or he wanted you to have his ass?
His ass.
At least there's some sort of decency involved. Okay. All right. And then when you saw the balls, like, hanging there from the back, you were like, nah. Nah. I think I'm going to pass on this
one. It looks like my dog.
Yeah.
Not really into my dog.
Look at that hairy man ass with the balls hanging there. I think I want to be faithful to my wife. I think I'm going to be fine right here. I'm going to go ahead and pull the plug. Okay, well, listen, James, I don't know, man. Yeah, so I believe you for some stupid reason. Mm-hmm. I believe you. No one else does. I don't think anyone else will. But, you know, take solace
into
my last question.
This is an important question, Mo. Should I tell my friends, my close friends? Or my girlfriend about this, you know, because I believe the experiment is successful.
No.
Yeah.
No, it's successful.
James, this is why, James, this is why I know. No. Listen, shut up, James. This is why I know you're telling the truth.
Yeah.
Absolutely, 100%. I believe you because you're stupid enough to also think that maybe you should tell your friends. In fact, that this experiment is to be celebrated. This experiment is not to be celebrated publicly. It's just for yourself. Right. And for myself and for our listeners, the 150,000 of them that will download this podcast, for Chopper, who's here, and for the staff that have heard this story.
Yeah.
But my thing is, dude, you are so – it's not naive. You're so detached from reality in terms of what you need to prove and how far you have to go to prove things. You're not supposed to go that far. You don't go, oh, listen, I think – I don't know if I have the capability of killing someone. Let me go and stab someone in the neck. And then after that, oh, nga no, hindi ko na kaya ulit. But you already did it. You don't commit. You're okay. You know this. There's a saying. There's a saying which is ask questions first. What you do is you shoot first and ask questions later. And you're not supposed to do that.
Yeah.
It's questions before. So don't relax. Don't get, you don't need to prove things to yourself. In actuality, just play with the thought in your head. And once you get your answer in your head, you can confidently say that that's where you stand.
Yes.
You don't have to see things happen for you to believe it. That's the key.
Right.
If nations, like, for example, it will go political. Taiwan, Philippines, you know, we have this thing. We don't have to see how far it goes before to realize it's a bad idea to fight.
Exactly.
We don't have to go tell China to fuck themselves and for fucking around in our area and then get into a fight for us to realize, oh, no, maybe we shouldn't have done that. You should already play it in your head. These things, we can assess and come to a conclusion. Yeah.
Next time you're feeling all Albert Einstein, before you do anything, call the show and ask Mo if you should test your theory.
Should I blow this up first? No. I'll tell you. It will blow up when you put it together. Mm-hmm. Don't worry about it.
And no, you don't tell anyone. You don't even write it in your Dear Diary.
Yeah.
Whatever. Just.
Yes. Thanks, James.
Yeah. Well, Mo, I'm really thankful that I actually called because I haven't talked to anyone about this, you know.
Good. And don't
forget it.
I'm kind of thankful about calling about this, you know. Yeah, that's all.
Okay. Thanks,
congratulations,
buddy.
James. You're straight.
Yeah. Wow. Yeah. Right. Yeah, that's right. Congratulations, you're straight. The lengths you went to confirm it, amazing. But you are, in fact, just as straight as you were a week ago before you decided to have your dick sucked by another dude. Thanks, man. Bye. Oh, God. My son, if I ever find out, did that. All right, take a break.
We'll return after this commercial break.
Ako po ay isang barbero. Ngunit ang ikukwento ko po sa inyo ay hindi kwentong barbero. Dati po kasi ay nagtatrabaho ko sa isang barberya sa bayan. Sa kasamaang palad po ay nasunog yun. Kaya nawalan ako ng trabaho. Kaya naisipan ko po na magdikit ng flyers ng globe number ko for home service. Hindi ko po akalain na makakaroon ako ng maraming customers. Dahil po sa dumami ang customers ko na taga iba't ibang lugar, nakaipon po ako ng sapat para makapagpatayo na rin po ako ng sarili kong barberya. Napagpatapos ko na rin ang aking mga anak sa pag-aaral. Kumanda na rin po ang aming buhay sa ngayon. Salamat sa Globe.
Hey, podcasters, Mo here. You ever watch the podcast, right? And you're sitting there and you're looking at our female celebrity guest and you're looking at her skin and you're like, wow, I'd love to have that complexion. Well, your answer is this. Glutamax, the official skin whitening partner of Miss Earth International. Available in capsules, soaps, lotion, deodorant, and face cream. Bikutis Mayaman with Glutamax. It's available in leading drugstores and supermarkets nationwide.
Take a little sunshine, grab a little rainbow, mix in a smile, stay for a while. Sabrina's Kitchen, what you waiting for? Sabrina's Kitchen, always room for one more. Sabrina's Kitchen, cooking up a storm. Sabrina's Kitchen, always something new.
Podcasters, listen up. Big announcement. The Chevrolet Sonic is a dependable five-seater subcompact vehicle, and it delivers sufficient power, fuel efficiency, refined ride and handling, and a remarkable entertainment system. The Sonic is the perfect Chevrolet vehicle for those who are looking to make their daily city commute or weekend getaway drives more fun and exciting. It comes in two great body styles, the five-door hatchback and a four-door sedan. Equipped with a new 1.4-liter Ecotec engine with double continuous variable cam phase, that's CVC, the Chevy Sonic provides efficient power and quality driving performance. Now, to further highlight the youthful, sporty, and fun characteristics of the Sonic, Chevrolet has equipped the compact sedan with high-tech convenient features such as Bluetooth connectivity and audio streaming capabilities that are commonly found only on high-trim compact sedans. The Chevrolet Sonic is available at all Chevrolet dealers. It comes with a Chevrolet 5-year warranty, 3-year free roadside assistance, and the services of a 24/7 Chevy hotline.
I was dared through Boss Man to eat a spoonful of, not sugar, but cinnamon. So you guys, I don't cower down to a challenge. I take them wholeheartedly and with spoonfuls. And I'm going to take a spoonful of cinnamon.
I saw this one, 1,000 Ways to Die, and the guy died. It was so sad.
Okay, now say chubby bunny.
I want to pull your lip. Are you here? Oh my god. She's gonna blow! You look like the Wicked Witch. So, how was your experience?
I need a raise.
My girlfriend says she hates me.
It's Good Times with Mo, the podcast. Call the show tonight and get your love problem answered.
Follow us on Twitter at GTWM Podcast.
And visit www.motwister.com.
Back on the podcast here on this Friday night. It is the 31st of May. Thanks for being here. It's Good Times with Mo, the podcast, season 2, brought to you by Globe. Phone number 478-7954. Don't forget, if you call us, you automatically get 3 movies for free from clickplay.ph. So, make it count. Skype, The Good Times Podcast. You can text us 092-736-0485. On the program tonight, my ex-co-host on the morning radio show. Her name is Angelica, or The Angelicopter. You can follow her on Twitter at The Angelicopter. And Chopper, I'm not going to say plug your shows because I know you're a corporate girl now. You are involved in IT, like Microsoft stuff, travel, yes. Country, the U.S., you yes. go to different parts of Asia and stuff like that. So life on the road for you. But good salary, happy with it, everything's
yeah,
cool?
Yeah, yeah. I get to travel with Lucas right now, so.
Good stuff, man.
A lot
good
of
for
fun.
You. All right. That's nice seeing you again, dear. Hopefully you can make several stops on the podcast as this season progresses. And I hope you're enjoying tonight's episode.
I am having a lot of fun.
Good. Let's get to it. A lot of calls tonight. So let's start with Moy, who is in Davao. Hi, Moy. Welcome to the show, my friend. How can we help you?
Hi, Mo. Actually, just what? Listening to your podcast. So,
oh, is yeah. it? Are you enjoying?
Yeah. So far, yeah. I'm laughing my ass out.
Oh, good. All right. Well, that's what you should be doing with your ass, laughing it out and not having anything enter. All right. Moy, how can we help you? What can we do for you?
I have a question about sex.
Sure.
What's the best position you can do to lessen the possibility of pregnancy?
To lessen? What sexual position to lessen the chance of pregnancy? 69 would be good.
Yeah.
Hard to get pregnant when you're 69ing. But that's about it.
How about the girl driving?
Anal. Yeah, thank you, Pico. Yeah, Pico, very, very, very big fan of anal. Anal is one.
No.
Yeah. Go ahead. It's going to be 69. That's the only way. Anytime your dick goes in her pussy, obviously you know that there's a good chance of getting pregnant. There is no sex position that is going to lessen that possibility. It is always going to be that case. Like, the moment you have sex unprotected, the chances of her getting pregnant are high. And there's no doggy style, cowgirl, reverse cowgirl missionary, buhat buhat, whatever it may be. Nothing is going to get in the way of that.
While I was having sex, I remembered something that I read in Yahoo News that...
Sure.
Like, if you do something like the girl on top, like, that gravity will help pull the semen down, so it won't...
No.
It will lessen the possibility. No. Something like that.
I can't believe... I don't even believe you that you saw that on Yahoo. That would not be true. That's irresponsible to even put that up there.
But something... A YouTube video, something documentary or something.
That would be what we call in our world bullshit. No, you can't do that. Sorry. Now, how about wearing a condom? Because then, you know, that will help. Birth control pills are solid. That's always my choice. It was always birth control pills for the girlfriends that I've been with, because then, you know, you don't have to use the condom. And you can do that. Now, you have to take the birth control pills on time, or else there's a chance that you're going to get pregnant, which, unfortunately, was what happened, like, in our part. So, birth control pills, condom, way to go. You should be fine. You can have all the sexual positions you want.
I have another question.
Quickly. Go ahead. Yeah, go ahead. Fire away.
Does a girl produce natural lubrication when you do an anal?
I don't know. That's a great... What do you mean? Lubrication for her butthole? Or does she get wet on her...
Like, if you have sex and put it in her vagina and something, then you get the love fluid, that's what they called it, or love something.
Maybe they call that in Davao the love fluid. Okay, fine. Are you saying her butthole lubricates? Are you saying that her butthole will lubricate if you give her anal sex? That's your question?
Yeah. Does girl produce lubrication?
No. I think the only thing that's natural that will naturally lubricate the asshole is like some sort of sweat or whatever current moist jelly-ish shit is inside her ass at the time. But that's why when you do anal sex, you definitely put a lot of lubrication on your dick and in the ass, because that's going to help put it in and out. But I've never done anal before, so I can't really tell you for sure. I would assume that that's the case, because all the people I know that do anal have to lubricate heavily before. Okay?
Okay.
All right. Sorry, Moy. Yeah, you know. Moy, you sound like you don't want to invest in condoms or lubrication. You gotta do both, buddy. You gotta spend a little money. Alright, whatever. Thanks for the call, bud. Appreciate it. We got a lot of calls to go to, so we gotta move on. Yeah, you gotta invest in some of that shit. Nothing's for free. Unless you wanna get pregnant or you want her to have a prolapsed anus.
Oh my gosh, a prolapsed anus, that's so ugly. Oh, that's scary.
Have you seen what it looks like?
Huh? My friend who's a nurse showed me because she was telling me.
Okay. She showed her anus?
No, she's showing you.
Oh, okay. Picture. Good lord. Like, what the kind of friends you have? Let's go to let's go to cell phone, because cell phone's been on hold a little longer. There's so many good calls here. I don't know which one I should take. Let's go to, what's the name of this guy? Dominic, 25. Hi, Dominic. How are you?
Hi. Hey.
Hey, buddy.
Hi, Angelica. Yeah.
Dominic, you are also in Batangas. How can we help you?
Yeah, I just have like a somewhat a curious question for you guys.
Sure, go ahead.
Much of a sex question. Yeah,
no problem.
Because I actually had like a girlfriend for 7 years. Way back in high school, actually 2003. We've been together for 7 years, and then just a few years back, she decided to go to Rome, Italy, with her family. And then she actually came back 2 years ago, and then we got separated with a reason of a long distance relationship. But she gone back just like last year, and then she told me that she wants me back. But then she needs to go back to Rome to fix her visa, and then she gone back. Actually, she's here right now in the Philippines. But the thing is, she's pregnant with another guy. And, of course, I love her, and I want her to be mine. But I'm just thinking about the kid that she has right now. I mean, it's a bit awkward if I will be getting a kid that's not mine, even if I love her. Now,
yeah, you're going to be insta-dad. Dominic, here's the thing about this, right? If you love her, and she didn't technically cheat on you, right? I mean, she didn't get pregnant when you guys were on, right? She got pregnant like when you guys weren't together. And you really feel strongly about her, then there's nothing wrong. She can be your girlfriend. You're going to be an instant dad. But there are a lot of guys out there that are instant fathers of children that are not theirs. And they absolutely are thrilled about it. They love the kids so much. It's thing. You'll be fine. If you really, in fact, love her that much. Oh, yeah, absolutely. Obviously, you should. Yeah. If you love her, then no problem. But you should also know it's not obviously it's not going to be as easy. And, you know, how old are you? You're 25?
Yeah, 25.
Yeah, you're okay. I mean, if you were a 19-year-old, I would tell you no, man, because being a father that early, you're going to really limit your thing, you know, your youth and all that stuff. But if you're 25, you really love her, you sound mature, you sound like a really great guy, you know, it might even be a perfect situation for all of you, for the child to come into a relationship where there would be a father figure that's a nice guy, for the girl to, you know, have someone that will actually take her even when she's pregnant and go through with it with her. You know what I mean? Like, she's not going to do it alone. And then there's you. You get to have the girl that you love. And fine, yeah, that kid is not yours, but so what? He can be yours because you're going to be there from day one. Dominic, you're going to be okay.
Yeah, and thanks for that. Okay, I just need to call in to ask your advice, man. I mean, thanks so much.
Yeah.
Angelica, thank you so much.
Yeah. You're super good. Dominic, I like you a lot, man. You're going to do fine. Congratulations.
Yes. And then later on, you can have more babies.
Night, guys. Okay.
Yeah. All right, buddy. Have a good one. Bye-bye.
Yeah. Good night. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Kid's all half Italian, too.
So far from there.
Yeah, it's going to be all good. Okay, comes out looking Matteo Guidicelli. And I'm putting it all right, man.
It's okay, instead.
Yeah. And then if she's a girl, you know, the kid's a girl, she's all super hot, then she can be an artista, then you can benefit from the money that she makes. Yeah, you're going to be in good shape, Dominic. Trust me. Let's go to Ariston, who's 21 on a cell phone. Ariston, you are on line 4. You're in Taguig. How can we help you? Ariston? We have line 4 cell phone and line 2 cell phone, if I'm not mistaken, right, Ange? So let's go to the line 4 one first, because he's been on hold longer. Ariston? From Taguig? No? Yes? Not there? Okay, let's go to line 2. Hold on. Ange, what are we at? I have line 4 here as a cell phone call and line 2 as a cell phone call.
No, it's not a cell phone call. He just said one day if it's landline number.
Ah, okay. So can you put him on hold, and we'll get
line 2 is the one that's on the cell phone.
Fantastic. Juancho, 22, Manila. What's up?
Hey. So is this Smoke Twister?
Yes, it is. Juancho, how are you?
Whoa! This is awesome. This is actually the first time I ever got patched through.
Yeah, so man. Thanks right for being now. Here. Yes, you are. Good. How can we help you? Good. Let me guess. You have something about your boyfriend?
Oh, what? Excuse me. I didn't hear that.
You have a boyfriend problem?
Actually, no, I'm straight, but I have a friend. Mm-hmm. Her name's Stephanie. She has a boyfriend problem, and she has she has like a really big problem right now, and it'd be cool, you know, if I got to ask about it.
Sure. Well, you're here. Ask away. How can we help you?
All right. So it goes like this. Stephanie has a boyfriend. They've been seeing each other for about 2 months.
Sure.
They've been seeing each other for about a month and a half, give or take. So they should be in their honeymoon phase, if I'm not mistaken. So they should
supposedly
all lovey-dovey. But
of course.
Apparently, once class started, the boyfriend started ignoring her for paperwork, which is really weird.
Hold on, I don't get it.
Ignoring her paperwork? Is that what I heard?
Boyfriend doesn't want to talk to her or hang out with her because he only wants to do paperwork, meaning, like, he's very busy at work.
Yeah, pretty much. It's not even work. We're students. We go to school.
Oh, we're students. Okay, school. All right, gotcha. Yeah. So?
So, yeah, that's pretty weird. And, so we thought it'd be cool if you just asked you.
It's a guy. She can talk to him and ask, hey, what's going on and stuff like that. And I'm sure she has. And if he says, well, love, we're in school and I need to study, that's a legitimate excuse for him. Because the thing is, maybe your friend
is actually studying. It's just paperwork for a school org. You know, it's not
but it's still school grade. Requirement. I mean, it's still school thing.
Yeah, what happens is, you're in college, your friend, the girl, she's like, okay, this is college, I'm gonna party, I'm gonna have friends. You know, I mean, like, she's in a different state of mind on what college offers, and this guy's in a different state of mind. He is, this is college, I gotta work my ass off, I gotta network, I gotta get involved, I gotta beef up the resume, and she's in the, well, I get to go out, I get to be, no uniform, people have different kind of outlooks of what college life is supposed to be like. Now, if she wants to have a boyfriend and he wants to have a girlfriend, but his number one priority in college is, in fact, college, then we're going to see this problem. And what course is it? Like, what if he's engineering or medicine or law or any of these courses that take up a lot of your time? Well, this is what she has to expect from the situation. Now, they're a month in, so she can always break up with him and probably not going to feel bad about it and find a guy that's more on the, more on the wavelength that she's at right now.
Oh, that's
the name
true.
That sounds
actually,
like Wancho.
Recently broke up with the guy.
Also, okay, broke
the, thing
up.
Is, the thing is, the guy still keeps on in contact with her. Like they're still together or something, but they're not.
That's also bad news for her. Listen, I think she's just in a different, she's in a different mindset. She's in, I just broke up with my boyfriend. I'm going to get another guy. I'm going to date him. I'm going to do this. She's having a little bit more fun. This guy's all business. That's completely normal. They're just in a different mindset about what's going on in their lives right now. It doesn't mean that he doesn't like her. It doesn't mean that he doesn't like her. It doesn't mean that he doesn't want her as a girlfriend. It's just she's second billing. Third billing, maybe even.
Absolutely.
A lot of girls like that.
A lot of sense, actually. Could you do me a favor?
Sure.
Like, could you tweet her that? Like, just maybe you're in a different way.
Yeah. Do me a favor. I don't know what her Twitter name is.
Okay. Here.
Great.
I'll tell you. Is it cool?
Now, how about this? How about you tweet me? Right now, I'll see it. I promise you, I'll tweet her back. It just because it makes it easier for me to just hit reply instead of writing it down because
true,
I'm fucking lazy.
All right, we'll tweet you right now. Thank you.
All right. So tweet me, and then I'll tweet her. And then, hey, by the way, this is my friend with a boyfriend who doesn't give a fuck. And I'm like, okay, gotcha. And then I'll go ahead and tweet her.
Okay, sure.
All right?
Okay.
All right. All right, Wancho.
Thanks.
Rock on, brother. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Yeah.
One more call. I know we got to go commercial break, but let me see if we can just take this one last one because she's been on hold for a long time. Malou?
Hi, good evening.
Hi, Malou. We'll take you and then we'll go to break. What's up, baby?
Okay, so here's the thing. My husband, I cheated on my husband recently.
You cheated? Oh, yes. Yeah, you cheated. Okay, fantastic.
Yes. So here's the thing. Is there a time frame for a man to forgive his wife or it depends upon the situation?
It depends on the guy, the situation, how far
frame?
The cheating. Well, I'll tell you this. No, there's not a time frame. But Okay, no, there's not a time frame. Everyone is an individual in terms of how they deal with this and relate to it. And there's the gravity of the cheating. Like, if it was he walked in on you while you were having sex with a guy, I'm going to tell you no. That doesn't. He's not going to get over that. Is it he saw your cell phone and made me go and think I miss you text and all of that stuff? It's going to take a while.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But actually, the wife of the the other man is the one who finds out and then met with my husband. So,
I like her. Yeah, that's my girl, man. I'll tell you that. Oh, I love that. I love that move. By the way, all of you, Chopper, that's a good move, man. Yeah. I love the wife that's proactive, catches the husband, and then goes out and fucking, you know, does something about it. Okay. What did he see on the phone? What was the message?
It was the wife. My message was like nothing much, just like I miss you, like that.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. On my defense, my husband cheated on me 3 years ago. So now, since I'm asking for forgiveness, he cheated on me again, maybe to pay back or what. And he's having a relationship right now and saying just to hurt me like that. But since we have two kids and I want to bring back my family again, I'm really hoping for that to happen. But it's 5 months ago. Up to now, we're not yet. Okay.
Yeah, you guys are almost at the point of no return.
Yeah,
Malu, this is it. You're really at the edge of the cliff here. Okay, it's time to either save or leave. Now, I want you to tell your husband everything you've told us. Meaning, I want to save my family. It's stupid. I think we're I've told that already to him.
Actually, he goes home every now and then. We have intimate relationship with each other, but every time he remembers what I did, he's like shouting at me, he's like cursing me, like that's
of
the
course,
thing I
that's
don't
what guys do.
Yes, that's normal. Yeah,
it's yeah, when
normal.
Guys get cheated on, it's ugly. Like I wish we had the girl mentality when we get cheated on, because it's so much pride involved in us and stuff, especially if it was a sexual relationship. Like, did you have sex with the other guy?
Yes.
Oh, man. Yeah. And he knows it?
Oh,
your husband
yes,
knows?
Of course. Yes. Oh, because I told him everything, so every detail, because I really want for us to get back together.
No.
Yeah. See, Chopper's here. She's pro lying about that, too, man. I'm telling you.
No, it's not that. It's just obviously. When a wife cheats on the husband, there's already a really big problem. Plus, you told us that he cheated on you prior. So your marriage is not stable. And what you're doing and what your husband is doing is not helping. So you have to be ready, because it doesn't look like it's going to get any better soon. Plus, also, I'm sure that it's not going to go back to the way it was. Like, good marriage, happy, no cheating. But you cannot clean the slate.
I think you can, but I think you're going to need a third party to
therapy,
put you guys back together. That's therapist, that's pastor, that's Jesus himself. I mean, whatever you use as a third party that kind of patches. Obviously, the both of you are not going to be able to do this together. Mm-mm. Even if you bring up the children and say all these kind of excuses.
Yes, can I add up? Because my husband wants me to go abroad and work there. Actually, I have my visa already. And that's his condition for us to get back together.
No.
Do you think it's a good idea?
That's an awful idea. That's a terrible idea.
That's not a good idea.
Yeah, no.
You're supposed to work on your relationship together. Physically, you have to be together to do that. Because you already have trust issues, the two of you. Because you both cheated on each other so many times. And you have children. There's a lot of things at stake. And there's already a lot of things that has been done. So why don't you, what Mo said, bring up therapy or if you're religious, your pastor or what have you.
You guys are not going to be able to fix it together. But here, let me ask you this one thing before we go. Hold on, what's your name again? Malu. You're 30. Okay, you're 30.
Yes.
So, are you sure that you want this guy for the rest of your life? But my thing is, you still have a very good chance of recovering if you guys split up. I know you have the two kids and all of these things, but let's get realistic. He is unhappy with you, as you are with him. You guys are in a very hurtful relationship. And mm-hmm. if the children are the only reason you're going to stay, I would suggest you not stay. That if you want to go abroad, you go abroad as a single woman and you move on as a single woman. Or if you want to stay here, do that as well. But you have to decide now, because I don't want you to be 40 years old and then finally separating from this guy and having a hard time recovering. Now, mm-hmm. I'm not saying you can't recover at an older age, but you're 30, meaning the decline is about to kick in.
Sayang.
Yeah, and you want to make sure you kind of be all you can be right now.
Yeah.
You know, if you're sure that you want him and you fucking in love with him, that's what I'm saying, then fine, mm-hmm. continue it. But if you're not 100% sure and you guys are just hating each other right now and hurting each other and fucking other people, yeah, occasionally you'll have sex with him, whatever. But it doesn't look good for you guys. And you're 30, you're right about to hit that mark where you should make the choice that's best for
you. Yeah. If you have your visa and you decide to go and go with your children, you'll be fine abroad. You can start
go
over.
Single,
it's a great chance. Yeah, be single. And, you know, 30 in the U.S. or in Europe is probably not like 30 in the Philippines. You probably have more chances of
finding better.
Yeah, you
probably look 27, 26. Yeah. You know, you get what I mean? Not that everything's about looks, but
it's just
the ability to recover, you still have that ability.
You need to gain your...
Not like if you were 45, 50, a little bit more difficult to recover at that age.
Mm-hmm.
You tend to suck it up the long. But don't suck it up.
No, don't.
You fucked up. He fucked up. Both of you guys fucked up. Both of you guys are fuck-ups. Whatever. Just make the decision about the rest of your life now.
Yes. And if he's not willing to do therapy or whatever, and it's just you, it's not going to work. If you're going to do all those other stuff, therapy, pastor counseling, marriage counseling, both of you has to be willing to do
it. Now, how old are your children?
7 and 3.
Yeah. I don't know.
7 years old.
Do you really love?
That's why I really want us for us to get back together. The plan of going abroad actually is, I will go first and then settle down, and then he said that he will go with me after.
Yeah, after he bangs 7 more starlets.
Yeah, or maybe he's so mad at you. You know, I'm so worried for this because I'm kind of in a situation where I left my husband for certain things and I'm with my son now and I want to start over. What I'm worried about this situation you're in is he tells you, okay, this is your, what if he's just pulling a revenge on you? Like, you'll fly away, I'll follow with the kids, yeah, we'll be fine, but then you're stuck here, you're stuck abroad and, you know, he's somewhere else.
Wait,
with the kids.
What country are you planning to go to?
Dubai.
Yeah,
I have my sister there.
Over this call. Yeah.
Nicole.
And you're going to bring your kids or you're going to leave them with the husband?
No, I'm going to leave them with my parents because actually he hasn't that have means to get my children. So I don't think that.
Yeah. No, Malu.
No, don't say that. That's not. That's what I told Malu. Myself. That's what I've learned.
Don't go abroad. Don't go abroad. Listen.
Mm-hmm. It's difficult.
It almost seems like going abroad is further from what you're trying to achieve, which is being a family.
Exactly.
If you don't want your husband around because you guys are hurting each other, then don't get him around. But don't leave your kids back.
Don't
leave your kids too, man. Then all of a sudden, you're furthest from what you wanted, which is a family.
Family.
You
exactly.
can still be a family mm-hmm. without your husband, okay? Don't go abroad. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Or bring them.
Bring them with you. If you're going to leave, bring them with you because remember, your parents don't have rights to your children. If you're abroad and if he wants to take your children from them, he has all the right to do so.
Hello?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. All right?
Okay.
Stay home
Thank you,
or bring your kids.
And Angelicopter.
All
Have
right,
a good evening.
Baby.
Good luck.
Thank you, Malu. Best of luck
Thank
to you.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Let us take a break. When we come back, we have a lot more questions for you guys, or from you guys. I think this is your last chance to get on the program, by the way, when we return. So make it count. 478-7954 is the phone number. Good Times Mo, the podcast. Sorry, the Good Times podcast on Skype. 092-736-0485 on the text line. Take a break. Back after this. Don't go away. It's GTWM Podcast brought to you by Globe.
Stay tuned. We'll return after this commercial break.
stars, we're always on the move. It's really important for us to get better and stronger for every competition that we get into. For all the different lifestyles that we have, some of us are graphic artists, filmmakers. We still find ways to get together. We put a lot of effort in practicing and rehearsing. Minsan may mga biglaang shows or auditions, so it's really important for us to get connected. I use my Globe group messaging to get a hold of everybody else. Malayo na rin ang narating namin, marami na rin kaming napuntahan. So it's really important to get connected.
Podcasters, listen up. Big announcement. The Chevrolet Sonic is a dependable 5-seater subcompact vehicle, and it delivers sufficient power, fuel efficiency, refined ride and handling, and a remarkable entertainment system. The Sonic is the perfect Chevrolet vehicle for those who are looking to make their daily city commute or weekend getaway drives more fun and exciting. It comes in two great body styles, the 5-door hatchback and a 4-door sedan. Equipped with a new 1.4-liter Ecotec engine with double continuous variable cam phase, that's CVC, the Chevy Sonic provides efficient power and quality driving performance. Now, to further highlight the youthful, sporty, and fun characteristics of the Sonic, Chevrolet has equipped the compact sedan with high-tech convenient features such as Bluetooth connectivity and audio streaming capabilities that are commonly found only on high-trim compact sedans. The Chevrolet Sonic is available at all Chevrolet dealers. It comes with a Chevrolet 5-year warranty, 3-year free roadside assistance, and the services of a 24/7 Chevy hotline. Hey, podcasters, Mo here. You ever watch the podcast, right? And you're sitting there and you're looking at our female celebrity guest and you're looking at her skin and you're like, wow, I'd love to have that complexion. Well, your answer is this. Glutamax, the official skin whitening partner of Miss Earth International. Available in capsules, soaps, lotion, deodorant, and face cream. Bikutis Mayaman with Glutamax. It's available in leading drugstores and supermarkets nationwide.
Take a little sunshine, grab a little rainbow, mix in a smile, stay for a while. Sabrina's Kitchen, what you waiting for? Sabrina's Kitchen, always room for one more. Sabrina's Kitchen, cooking up a storm. Sabrina's Kitchen, always something new.
Familiar with a game Chubby Bunny, but
what's like?
Have you played Chubby Bunny before?
No.
You put a marshmallow in your mouth. You say Chubby Bunny, and you keep putting it in your mouth. And you keep saying Chubby Bunny.
Okay.
Whoever can fit the most in their mouth wins. But we're not gonna say Chubby Bunny. We're gonna have a conversation.
Okay.
Perfect. Yeah. So I'm gonna ask you, okay, ka na ba?
Okay.
And you're gonna be like, okay na.
Okay.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah.
Go.
Two at a time?
Yeah, we're gonna do two at a time. Okay,
can I
what?
Okay, no, okay, no. I just saw it.
Okay, can I bat?
Okay, no, okay, no.
Okay, can I bat?
Okay, no, okay, no.
What? Okay.
Girlfriend says she hates me.
It's Good Times with Mo, the podcast. Call the show tonight and get your love problem answered.
Follow us on Twitter at GTWM Podcast
and visit www.motwister.com.
Back on the show, it is Friday, 31st of May, 2013. It's Good Times with Mother Podcast, brought to you by Globe. We are in season 2. On the show tonight is the Angelicopter, good friend of mine, co-host of the radio show before. Now she is a corporate big time corporate star in America.
No.
That's right. Traveling the country, knocking them dead. You can follow her on Twitter.
Don't say that.
You can follow her on Twitter at the Angelicopter. Phone number 478-7954. Skype the Good Times Podcast. Text 092-736-0485. Last chance for your calls to get on the show tonight. Don't forget, we want to thank clickplay.ph for giving away 3 free movies to every single person that calls the show. Also, you can win an iPad mini. If not, we have a variety of other prizes we'd love to give away. Are you ready to get your game on? Chevrolet Philippines brings you the Chevrolet Sonic, a sportish and stylish subcompact car that has 1.4-liter Ecotec engine with 6-speed automatic transmission that provides dependable speed, power, and fuel efficiency. The Chevrolet Sonic is also equipped with high-tech features such as steering wheel mounted audio controls with USB auxiliary and Bluetooth full audio streaming connectivity. Sonic is available in hatchback and sedan variants, so dare not take on life's challenges head-on and complement your A-game with the all-new Chevrolet Sonic. Visit your near Chevrolet dealership or log on to chevroletsonic.com.ph to check out the all-new 2013 Chevrolet Sonic. Game on. Okay, let's get to it. Chopper, you ready?
Yes, game.
Let's go to Al and talk to him. Hi, Al. You are 23 in San Paolo. Cool. Sorry, 21 in San Paolo.
I'm 21,
what's up,
yes.
Buddy? Yeah. How can we help you, Al?
Yeah, I just need an advice because I'm currently making a stupid decision life-changing decision right now. Yeah.
Okay,
there's this person that I really like. He's a friend
what's
of mine.
What's his name?
Can you hear me, guys?
Yeah. It's a boy. Yes?
Yes.
Okay. Of course. Continue.
And then, at first, because I was a fresh graduate back then, and then this is my first job. And then we met during the interview, and then when we got employed, because at first I was very hesitant to be friends with him because I was very selective when it comes to talking to people or being friends with people. I thought he would just be an ordinary person in my life, but eventually, as we get along, I develop a crush on him. And then after 3 months, you know, when they say if it lasts more than 3 months, it's no longer a crush. I'm in love already. And then at first I was in denial, and then I'm in love. And then for me, our friendship is very special on my part, and then I don't want to mess up. That's why I plan to resign, and then
oh my god,
yeah, very stupid, right? Because
no, you're not stupid. You're dramatic. Stop being dramatic.
Yeah, I'm very dramatic. And then I got this opportunity to work abroad. And then I grabbed it just so our friendship be saved. No, now I wonder.
What are you?
Is it really?
You watch
too much
soap operas.
Yeah, I'm confused.
Wait, hold on. What country are you going to? Please tell me it's in the Middle East. So they'll
not
find out you're homosexual
in the US.
And then stone you. Okay, good. All right, fair enough. Where in the US?
San Francisco.
Not sure the state yet. But it's in the US. It's an internship. It's a program.
Okay. All right. Okay.
And I'm leaving
one
on
of the major
July
cities.
Or late July or first week of August.
Okay, you're leaving in 1 month and you don't even know where you're going?
Because, not yet.
Are you
what
sure
you
you're
mean?
In control of your life?
Because it's a program. I mean, they haven't assigned the
hotel there
are
options, like...
for me. The hotel where I'll be working in. Not yet. I don't know the hotel yet.
Oh, because you're
it's
HRM
like,
kind of
okay.
Hotel restaurant. Okay, all right, fine. Fair enough. Okay, so what's your question?
Yeah, is it right to make nasty decisions just so the friendship is saved or won't be messed up?
No.
Because it's against my will going abroad just to save our friendship.
Okay. Wow, you are so dramatic, my friend.
Very dramatic,
Al.
Yeah.
I like you too, Naman. I mean, you sound like a very pleasant guy, and you sound upbeat. I wonder where all this comes from, because you really sound like you're put together well. You sound happy, you sound optimistic, and you sound happy-go-lucky.
Yeah.
Where the fuck is all this drama coming from? God damn it. All right, Al. Wait. Is this guy gay too, or is he straight?
You know, screw labels. I don't think I'm gay.
No.
It's important in this situation.
Chopper's correct.
No.
I'm telling you.
Have you guys heard about the terms sapiosexual or sapiosexual? You get turned on by the intelligence
of
a person.
I've heard of I don't like dick, and I like pussy, and I like dick, and I don't like pussy.
Yeah,
I've
heard
that.
There's no in between.
Yeah. You know what I told him? I don't like him. I'm not attracted to him. I'm attached to him. You know, I'm emotional.
Like me.
My emotional investment in him is quite big.
The problem is you didn't put a label, so you had some sort of false kind of hope or whatever, and then it's bothered you so much that you're moving abroad. You have to put the label, because the label might in fact stop you from making these incredibly dramatic decisions. Like, if you told me right now he's a straight guy, I'm telling you you're stupid, because he's never going to like you.
Exactly.
And you're making all of these wild decisions for something, regardless of how strongly you feel about him, it's not going to ever materialize. Now, if you refuse to put labels on these things, then that's what keeps you in this gray area. And it's in this gray area that you do stupid, irrational, and dramatic, and just out of the blue, life changing decisions because of something that's in the gray area.
Yeah, if you're sure that he's straight, if you label it and you know that he's straight, he can't even break up with you. So why move abroad? You know, I mean,
he
can't even dump you.
And there's no friendship to save because there's no problem there.
Yeah,
because there's no existing dilemma. There's no existing conflict of interest. Now, if you told me he was a gay guy, then I would still tell you not to move, but I would say, okay, you can handle it a little bit differently. If he's a straight guy, there's no way in fucking hell you guys are going to get together. So stop making these wild, you know, decisions regarding your life that has nothing to do with whether you guys are going to be together or your friendship.
If there's even that possibility that you guys can be together because he's gay, I would tell you, stay, tell him how you really feel, if you're really in love, and don't make like, I'm going to move because I don't want to ruin our friendship because I'm in love with him and it's going to ruin everything. It could be the greatest, but it could be the worst.
Yeah, at least you know you could be moving into another a great opportunity, but I don't want him to be the reason.
Exactly.
I don't want your friendship to be the reason that you move away. And
that's
so far right now, it is. Okay, is he gay or not?
That's what they told me.
Is he gay or not? How about this? Does he look like he's ever sucked a dick?
No.
Okay.
He hasn't been in a relationship yet.
Okay. Is he gay?
I'm not sure, but I think he's not straight.
You hope he's not straight?
I think you hope he's not straight. I think you hope he's gay. That's why this is all the drama. It's like, I'm going to leave because I can't get him because I feel that he's straight. I feel like there's no chance for us. I think that's what it is. And I think if you're going to leave, Mo's right. Leave for the opportunity. I think that's a great opportunity for you to take an internship abroad. But also, don't put it in your heart that you're leaving because of him or because of the relationship that you cannot have with him.
Okay.
So the answer is...
Okay, no. No, the answer is this. I even forgot the question. The answer is, you're not saving any friendship. You're not ruining any friendship. I want you people to stop... Fucking okay. Remember earlier on the program we said these things. The more common calls on the show are premature ejaculation. Here's another one. Oh, I'm in love with my friend, but I don't want to ruin the friendship. I want to save the friendship. Stop it, people. You guys are so fucking dramatic, old school bullshit. There's no friendship to be destroyed, and there's no friendship to be saved. It is just in fact that you guys are friends. One likes the other, and if there's no future in it, in terms of a romantic future, you guys are still fucking friends.
Yeah.
You know,
what
you're right, Mo. I'm smiling right now because I'm realizing or I'm thinking of these things. Yeah, I never... Yeah, you're the best advisor, Mo.
Thank you, I know that. Listen,
you might have a career in this, Mohan.
Yeah, listen, please. Unless you want to move abroad because of the opportunity for your career, do not go there because of this. He's still going to be your friend.
Yeah.
Man,
actually,
I've had gay friends. I've had gay friends who have told me, my God, I would just so fuck you if you wanted me to fuck you. Or like, and I'd be like, no, I don't want you to fuck me because I'm not gay. But I still am like your greatest pal. Like, you have to understand that.
Yeah.
We're still the greatest of pals. Man, I won't fuck you, but I'll kill somebody for you if they hurted you. If they hurted you.
If they hurted you.
ba yun?
I was gonna say, they fucked with you, but
also, he knows you're gay, right? I mean, don't try to be hiding that from him. That
yeah, if he knows you're a very good point, Chopper. If he knows you're gay and he's still your friend, then you, in fact, have the best setup possible.
Yeah, he knows you're gay.
Knows you're gay. He knows you're in love with him, and he's still your pal. That's the best you can get. That's the best you can get.
I want a gay friend.
I couldn't agree more.
It's not what you want, but it's the best you have for you. Okay?
Yes. I understand that.
That'd be cool. Even if a girl came up to me and said, Mo, we've been friends for a certain amount of years, and I'm super in love with you. I think I'm going to move abroad now because I can't handle it. I'm going to be like, shut up. Sit down. We're going to hang out every day still. Even if you want my balls, we're still going to be pals. Ew. Nothing is going to materialize, but you have to know I still love having you around. That is what happens. Please, all of you, stop removing this. I'm going to ruin the friendship provincial bullshit. Stop it. Are you from the province?
I'm sorry?
No, you're from Sampaloc. You're Sampaloc. Yeah, it's like provincial of Manila.
Yeah, I'm from the province. Yeah.
Okay, yeah. Enough of that provincial bullshit. Come on. Hey, province, I'm just fucking with you. Just kidding. Look at Cebu earlier. Always so wild. So much more city than
you know,
we are.
Ellen is from Cebu also.
Oh, man, that Ellen and Darna, what a wild thing. All right. Thanks for the call.
No problem. And thanks for the advice. I get to realize these things. And if not because of you or your advice, I won't realize those things that come.
Yeah, but please do me a favor. Find out where. Next thing you know, you're gonna be offered the Waldorf Astoria in New York. Go.
Four seasons.
It might be some fucking great hotel. So,
kahit may drama, okay lang go. Yeah,
but if it ends up being like a Radisson in somewhere in like North Carolina, then yeah, just stay home.
Yeah, or Best Western or whatever. Yeah. No, don't do that.
Only if it's an awesome opportunity in a great city: San Francisco, New York, Miami, Los Angeles, Chicago.
But the cost of living in there is high.
It is. That's right. But hey, it's a great opportunity if you can pull it off. Okay?
Great opportunity versus the friendship. Oh, my God.
There's no versus.
Just listen, buddy. You're still going to be friends if you go abroad because you are only just, in fact, friends.
Exactly.
And Skype, you can do all of those things.
Yeah, that's what he told me.
If I had a gay friend who really liked me, and he said, Mo, I'm super in love with you. Can you just please deal with it? I'm like, okay, I'll deal with it. And then he's going, can we Skype and can I just masturbate to you on camera? And I'll be like, okay, I just don't want to look at you. I'll turn my camera, turn your camera off, but I'll just sit there and surf the internet and you can make bate all you want. I would do that for them. I would do that for them. I'm just saying.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Just putting it out there. Can someone please tweet John Lapos and say that?
Yeah, there you go. John Lapos is a great example. John Lapos is like, sige na, putong na, huwag mo na di mo ko ng beses. I'm like, no, but I'll go out drinking with you alone. We'll get drunk as shit and I'll hang out with you and you can walk around in your underwear, no problem. I've had plenty of gay guys who walk around their underwear who would fuck me at a moment's notice. But it's fine with me, man. Trust me. You're going to be fine. Okay, let's go to Eric, and this should be the last call of the night. Hi, Eric, 16 years old.
Hello, Mo. Hello.
What's up?
I have a problem.
Girl, go.
I'm very confused if I should shift my course, because my course is HRM, and I want to go to Comm Arts. HRM.
No.
No, don't.
Don't ever go to Comm Arts. None of you, ever. Don't ever go to Comm Arts. Don't do it.
Why?
Hold on 1 second. Shut up. Staff, any of you guys Comm Arts here? Interns for Comm Arts? Nope. No? Good. You see?
Why?
Because it gets... You can do everything that you want in Comm Arts with another degree.
Exactly.
A better degree.
But I think HRM is not for me because I want to talk and talk. I want to host. I want to be like you.
Yeah, you know what I majored in? You know what my course was? Poli-sci, legal management, aviation science. Nothing had to do with Comm Arts. Yet I'm sitting here doing a podcast and I have a radio show. You don't have to be Comm Arts to get into this business. And I prefer that you don't be... I'm sorry?
But I'm not that really happy with HRM. I'm not
Then take something else.
Yeah, take something else.
Don't take HRM.
Don't go Comm Arts. Don't go Comm Arts, please. Only because I want you to have a good backup plan. There's so many Comm Arts students. There's fucking 100,000 people that are mass comm Comm Arts, but there's only jobs available nationwide to be a broadcaster. You know, it's just, it's such a difficult field to get into. And like, okay, you take my radio station that I work for, right? How many of our DJs are comm arts majors? Maybe zero. Certainly not more than one. Maybe one. That's it. Everyone else is from something else.
I think Grace.
So what do you recommend?
No, Grace is Grace was
in Ateneo Community.
Yeah. No. She was like international studies or some shit like that.
Oh yeah. Yeah. Don't take comm arts. Take some. I don't take English literature. Yeah.
Give me one solid course that you can do something with afterwards. Like a very specific course.
IT.
IT solid.
IT. They pay super, a lot of money.
IT super solid. Man, business, anything like that, just please.
And if you say that you can talk and you want to talk and you talk well, and then you're in IT, which they lack a lot of techie guys
who speak well, like casually speak well.
Yeah, then you have a safe fallback. No, don't take it. You have a safe fallback.
If you don't want HRM, don't take HRM. But
just don't take comm arts.
Okay, if you want to take comm arts, because you're 16 years old, and I don't want, if you want to take comm arts, Eric. I don't want to tell you not to do it because you're in college and you should do what you want to do. But I'm just telling you, if you don't have to be comm arts major to be a radio DJ. You don't have to do it. And a lot of us radio DJs, I would feel guilty if I told you don't take comm arts, but it's really what you want. If you want to take it, then take it.
Yes.
But I would love, and I always tell this to students, you don't have to be a comm arts major to be a radio DJ. And it would be great if you had a specific course that you would take as a backup plan, just in case your radio dreams don't materialize.
Because radio salary don't really pay well.
Yeah, radio salary is awful anyway.
Yeah. So if
unless you're a superstar, like me,
yes, I want to be a superstar.
Well,
but
you
the
listen.
Chances are not that I'm saying you're not good because I don't know, but the chances of becoming a superstar you have to be, it's slim. And second, you have to have a backup just in case it doesn't.
Yeah,
happen.
That's where I'm more of a backup just in case your radio dreams don't pan out, because it's not like the comm arts people are gonna tell you how to be funny. They're not gonna teach you how to be interesting. They're not gonna teach you how to be witty. That's just you. If you are in fact that, then you can find a career on radio with a degree that has nothing to do with comm arts.
You know, maybe putting it another way, my sister, when she was deciding on what course to take, she wanted to pay a 4-year course in either photography or culinary. And I said, you know what? Let's not do that. You have to have a backup plan. Maybe think of what you want. And then she said, maybe special education for children. And that's very specific. And I said, yeah, that's good. And then after you graduate, if you want to take summer courses on photography or culinary, then you can do that. And if you're a really great chef or a really great photographer, it will happen for you. Just have a backup plan.
I would I would be happy if you told me you're taking up nursing instead of comm arts.
Yes.
Yeah. Really, to be honest.
I would think really IT
because
more than nursing.
You have to think about money, Eric. Money, money, money. Where's the money going to come from? If you want to be a radio DJ, fine. But you can do it by taking a course that directs you towards a little bit more money.
I think a lot of the radio DJs either have other business on the side or they have other gigs or what they call rackets, you know, or
na walang relation sa comm arts.
Sa comm arts, yes. Because they have fun being a radio DJ, they're doing their passion, they speak well, but at the same time you gotta pay the bills.
Mo Chopper.
Yeah.
May I speak?
Oh, yes, sure.
Yeah, this is Miguel. Yeah. No, comm arts, just to defend it, no? Not for the hosting part, not for, you know, being a talent, but if he's going for the, like, as a director, you know, for commercial work.
Sorry. Yeah, okay, Miguel, I see where you're at. Okay, that's why I don't want to feel guilty. I don't want to tell people don't take comm arts, because if that's what they really want and their heart tells them and they're, it says the word art right there, and art means less money. Now, if he wants to be commercial director, fine. But Miguel, you of all people know that to be a commercial model, a commercial
director,
come on, man, you know how fucking
to get your foot in there is very difficult. You have to start from the very bottom.
Right, and that could be
production assistant.
Fucking 15, 20 years of bottom.
Yeah.
right?
All that. Yeah, utosan, utility, ganyan. That's where you start.
Yeah, now there are a lot of young directors that burst into the scene, but come on, look at these.
They're very
kids.
Well they're connected. They're super well connected.
Yeah, that's what it is. That's what it is. They're not
or their
that,
dad is a director.
Yeah, that's what it is. They're not talented. They've got connections, man. They're sikat. They're hip. Yeah, their parents are this.
Hey, wait. I have a lot of friends who are really good. So there are good ones. It's just that there are a lot that, you know, have really good connections.
Everything is easier if you do have the network or connection.
Of the 2 million students that are taking either mass comm or comm arts right now, how many superstars in the 2 million students that are currently enrolled in all the universities in Manila?
3, 4, maybe.
Yeah. You see? So if I told you that of 2 million engineering students, only 2 or 3 would be successful, you think people would still take engineering? Of course not. Those are courses that fire out a greater percentage of successful individuals. And when I say successful, I'm talking about financially successful, because that's very important. Doctors, true, stuff like that. I mean, yes, they're difficult courses to take, but you are, once you come out, you have a really great kind of path pictured or a path put out for you. Comm arts, so difficult, man. You take comm arts, you come out of there, the competition's immense, it's intense, and the people who are actually making money hand over fist were never comm arts majors anyway.
True.
Okay. You know, it's scary. That's all. But if you love it, then do it. I mean, I'd feel guilty if you didn't.
But this is the classic, because we're already here. We're older than you. We've seen it. We know we're telling you what to do. But I know you're in that stage where I want to do what I want. This is my chance. So.
And one last thing. And again, a comm arts, please don't hate me. I'm just saying. I've seen so many of you guys come through and asked for interviews and all of that stuff. How many of you truly even communicate very well? Only a few of you. Actually do communicate very well.
And they don't need the course for that.
Exactly.
Yes, you don't need comm arts for
it. I have another question. Can I?
Yes, go.
What should I say to my father? Because he really doesn't like my course. And kasi sabi niya, baka servidor lang ako after my course. Alalay, waiter.
Oh, for HRM.
And I can't stand it anymore.
But you also don't like HRM. I mean you're not happy with HRM right now.
Yeah, you're unhappy with it anyway. Okay, I'm going to treat you, Eric, like you were my son. If you came up to me and said, Dad, HRM, I'd be like, nah, is there nothing else you want to take? If you go, Dad, I'd be like, really? Is there anything? Because I would say the same things. Ang hirap mag-HRM kasi yun nga, you're going to end up working this position and that position before you get to the position that you want. I want my son, when he's out of college, maybe he'll take one entry-level position and then jump to something that he's really happy with. HRM, you're going to have to do maybe 7 to 8 to 10 positions before you finally get the one you want. Same with comm arts. I would just like to see you get into your career at an early age in your mid-20s, and you're off and running already. And what courses are those? Business courses, maybe? Engineering courses? IT courses? Like, you think in IT, I don't know. Miguel, maybe I need you back again because you're an IT guy. Now, I don't know if you were an IT major. I'm going to say maybe not. You didn't take up IT.
I was.
You fucked around.
I was.
Okay. I thought maybe you're one of those guys that fucked around with computers.
I did.
Oh, with your computers. Okay. All right. Fair enough. But when you're an IT guy, right, Miguel, and help me, this is my assumption. When you graduate from your IT course, don't you just jump into IT jobs? You don't have to wash IT dishes first.
No.
You don't have to kiss too much IT ass of the big time IT guy. It's more like you jump in, you know your craft, you know what you can do.
You're hired.
And people respect you immediately the moment you can network administrate the fuck out of something.
Yes.
Or the moment you can code the shit out of something.
But of course you have to start as a trainee, right? Because what they teach in school really isn't, you know, what you do at work. So you have to do a few months of training, and then after that, you do what you do.
Yeah, but you're respected within your first, say, 2 to 3 years. You're in good shape.
Well, that depends on your, siempre, how you do things. Of course, if you're you're tamad or whatever, then voila.
Obviously. But all I'm saying is you can be a fantastic hotel restaurant management student, and it's going to take fucking forever to finally get to the job that you want. You're not, you know why? Because they're going to look at your resume and they go, we want 10 years, 5-star managing experience before you can get to run this hotel.
You might never even touch the stove.
Reach that point. Exactly.
See?
It might just be washing dishes.
That's the reality.
I'm telling, take something like nursing or IT or...
The nursing is so fucked out already, though. You know, that's the thing.
Because you have to have your papers to go abroad.
Well, yeah, and there's 15 million students doing nursing, and none of them really want to be nurses. Like, how many of the nursing students really want to be nurses? Like, 5%? It's just because it's a great paycheck once you get done with it.
We pay our IT guys, and they're not even the highest level guys, $200 an hour.
That's nuts.
Yep.
That's a guy who doesn't have to speak well.
Exactly.
He doesn't have to have a great command of the English language. He can have grammar Nazi problems like a motherfucker, but he knows his IT stuff, yeah. And they're getting paid, man.
Yeah. Yeah. And we recruit them from all over the world because there's just a huge demand for it. $200 an hour, and that's starting.
Nuts.
I should have taken IT.
Now, Eric, again, if you're asking Kuya Mo, who is more than half your age, or more than twice your age, if you want Calm Arts, brother, take Calm Arts.
Yes.
I'm telling you. If you want to be a radio superstar, take Calm Arts, man. But you can be a radio superstar with a degree in computer science.
Okay.
All right. All right.
Thank you.
And this is really the great debate because, man, I don't want to hurt the feelings of students who put so much hard work into their course and then just to have me go up here and say, oh, that's a bullshit course. It's not a bullshit course. I'm not saying that. And for all you Comm Arts students who are valedictorians and whatever, you guys are 50,000 times smarter than I am and probably can edit the fuck out of a video and put together a killer breaker for, or can public speak or speech write better than anything I could ever do. That's true. There's so many of you out there that are extremely talented. I'm only going on the monetary side of everything. Are you going to make a lot of money?
Do you
and
have
if
a
you
back-
don't like money, yeah. then fucking take home arts. But I like money.
Okay. Okay.
Money's fun. Makes you can buy shit with money.
You can buy a radio station and put up your own radio show or podcast.
You can buy stuff
if
with
you have money.
Money. By the way, here's the smartest thing I've ever said on the history of radio or podcast. You can buy stuff with money.
Oh my
genius!
God.
Right?
It's a breakthrough.
Write that down. Write it down. No, really. That's what my point is. It's not the course itself. It's the opportunity and the ability to earn a lot of money afterwards is what I worry about for you. I want you guys to be able to work to earn a lot of money and do it by taking difficult courses with jobs that are in demand after you graduate and then fuck around, be a radio DJ on the side or go ahead and scratch that itch. And maybe while you're studying to be an engineer or while you're studying to be in your IT or while you're studying to be these courses that I'm talking about, on your free time, mess around. Go join a group for communication arts org. Go to our radio station and be a junior jock where we take students from schools. And you don't have to be Calm Arts to be
a junior
jock or a student DJ at Magic 89.9. You can be from any fucking course.
Or Miguel will hire you.
Yeah, or Miguel will hire, but you have to be lesbian or homosexual.
That's right.
To be on this podcast.
Or at least try to make out with someone.
We only hire gay guys. Yeah. Miguel, we only hire gay guys, correct? And lesbians.
We don't know that, but that's what happens.
You did not intend.
They become gay when they see Miguel and like, okay, this is the place for me.
Yeah.
No, but Miguel, okay, hold on one second. Cause again, we're super late. We're completely over time, but am I completely off
with the gay stuff or the advice?
No. There are really a very small number of super successful people in this industry.
Yeah, it's hard, man. It's hard, and that's it. I guess I don't want to hurt anyone's feelings. If you're a student of Comm Arts, I don't want you to go fuck you, Mo, because I've seen a good majority of students be mad at me because I said this on the radio or, you know, when they come up and interview me at the station, they're like, Mo, we're Calm Arts students. I'm like, okay, off the record, man, you're going to have a hard time being, I say it because you know what? Miguel, here's another one. Here's another one, Miguel. Fuck, get back on the microphone.
Yeah.
You want to be a superstar radio DJ? Guess what? You better look like a model.
Yeah, that's true.
You better look like a fucking model.
For some reason, radio stations now have cameras.
Yeah. Yeah.
For some reason.
Eric, if you don't look like fucking Daniel Matsunaga, there's no chance of you being a radio DJ. I'm sorry. That's just the truth.
I'm shy being great right now.
Yeah, you better. You see, the thing, you know what's more important than learning how to put two sound effects together and all that? Going to the dermatologist. That's just as important
if you want to be a radio DJ.
That's just as important. And that's awful, awful truth.
And I'm planning to be fit and to whiten my skin.
You know, the new batch of male radio DJs right now, they're a lot good.
Yeah, you know, there's a packet that when we hire you for radio, there's a packet that we give you. It has glutathione, hair gel, it has like slimming pills. I mean, you have to be good looking these days. It's weird.
Yeah.
But it is what it
I'll
is.
I'll prepare for that.
Thank you. You know, okay,
I'll
for example.
Miguel right now.
Okay, for example, Miguel, I don't know. Do you know Francesca of RX 93.1? Recently, now this is the rumor. Got fired from RX. You know why?
Why?
Because she was old.
No.
That's it. Dude. One of the great radio people in the business. Nice, fantastic, knows her shit, technically sound.
She's technically
sound.
She speaks well.
Well, fucking extremely eloquent. Yeah. Great radio voice. Good command of just everything radio. 10 times the DJ that I am, Francesca of RX. I was the biggest fan, and I fucking hate RX for it. But this is what I hear, and she's been saying goodbye on Twitter recently, and people in the radio business, people at her station have told me that, hey, Mo, I gotta tell you something. Don't say anything. We're letting Fran go. Why? She's just a little too old, man. I'm like, what is she? Like, she's my age. I'm sorry. You mean you guys will keep Jinri Park?
I was going to say
and Karen
Bordador,
the pieces of shit radio DJs that they are, because they're young and attractive, and you're going to let one of the true gems go because she's running a little old? Are you fucking serious? And that is the status of our business.
Fine, I understand keeping Jinri Park, but I don't understand keeping Karen.
Both of those DJs are fucking off. Karen, if you ever hear this, you fucking suck. And so do you too, Jinri. Well, you guys are fucking shit DJs. No, and Fran is awesome, and she's getting the boot because, again, allegedly, she's a little older now. Good God.
Why don't... You know, Fran should be magic.
That's all. You want to be in this business, Eric, now? Jesus.
You got to look like Jinri.
You got tits? Sorry. Can't be on this. Can't be rated DJ. Got to look... Go get implants or whatever.
I know. That's what I did.
Eric, sure. I hope we brighten your 16-year-old mind. Thank you for being on the show.
Jesus.
Godspeed, sir. Godspeed.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Bye-bye.
He's going to be a surgeon.
I have a feeling Karen is going to hear that.
I don't care.
The weather Jejim wouldn't like. Spelling. Okay.
Karen.
We got to go, guys, right? We're late. Was I overboard? Miguel, are you going to edit that whole part out?
Which one? Of what? Since when did you start editing?
Shut up, Chopper. You fucking still talk so much, no?
Let's ask the chat. Hey, chat people.
Okay.
Can you guys say, should we edit that out?
I say no.
I thought we were off.
Let's take a break. When we come back, we're going to wrap up the program, find out who caller of the night is. You can win yourself an iPad mini on this Friday night. It is the 31st of May. It's good time to roll the podcast. Season 2, brought to you by Globe. Don't go away.
Stay tuned. We'll return after this commercial break.
Ako po ay isang barbero. Ngunit ang ikukwento ko po sa inyo ay hindi kwentong barbero. Dati po kasi ay nagtatrabaho ko sa isang barberya sa bayan. Sa kasamaang palad po ay nasunog yun. Kaya nawalan ako ng trabaho. Kaya naisipan ko po na magdikit ng flyers ng Globe number ko for home service. Hindi ko po akalain na makakaroon ako ng maraming customers. Dahil po sa dumami ang customers ko na taga iba't ibang lugar, nakaipon po ako ng sapat para makapagpatayo na rin po ako ng sarili kong barberya. Napagpatapos ko na rin ang aking mga anak sa pag-aaral. Kumanda na rin po ang aming buhay sa ngayon. Salamat sa Globe.
Hey, podcasters, Mo here. You ever watch the podcast, right? And you're sitting there and you're looking at our female celebrity guest and you're looking at her skin and you're like, wow, I'd love to have that complexion. Well, your answer is this. Glutamax, the official skin whitening partner of Miss Earth International. Available in capsules, soaps, lotion, deodorant, and face cream. Bikutis Mayaman with Glutamax. It's available in leading drugstores and supermarkets nationwide.
Take a little sunshine, grab a little rainbow, mix in a smile, stay for a while. Sabrina's Kitchen, what you waiting for? Sabrina's Kitchen, always room for one more. Sabrina's Kitchen, cooking up a storm. Sabrina's Kitchen, always something new. Sabrina's Kitchen, table's waiting for you.
Podcasters, listen up. Big announcement. The Chevrolet Sonic is a dependable 5-seater subcompact vehicle, and it delivers sufficient power, fuel efficiency, refined ride and handling, and a remarkable entertainment system. The Sonic is the perfect Chevrolet vehicle for those who are looking to make their daily city commute or weekend getaway drives more fun and exciting. It comes in two great body styles, the 5-door hatchback and a 4-door sedan. Equipped with a new 1.4-liter Ecotec engine with double continuous variable cam phase, that's CVC, the Chevy Sonic provides efficient power and quality driving performance. Now, to further highlight the youthful, sporty, and fun characteristics of the Sonic, Chevrolet has equipped the compact sedan with high-tech convenient features such as Bluetooth connectivity and audio streaming capabilities that are commonly found only on high-trim compact sedans. The Chevrolet Sonic is available at all Chevrolet dealers. It comes with a Chevrolet 5-year warranty, 3-year free roadside assistance, and the services of a 24/7 Chevy hotline.
I was dared through Boss Man to eat a spoonful of, not sugar, but cinnamon. So you guys, I don't cower down to a challenge. I take them wholeheartedly and with spoonfuls. And I'm going to take a spoonful of cinnamon.
I saw this one, 1,000 Ways to Die, and the guy died. It was so sad.
Wow. Okay, now say chubby bunny.
I like the pull of your lip. Are you here? Oh my god. She's gonna blow! You look like the Wicked Witch.
So, how was your experience? I need a raise.
My girlfriend says she hates me.
It's Good Times with Mo, the podcast. Call the show tonight and get your love problem answered.
Follow us on Twitter at GTWM Podcast.
And visit www.motwister.com.
We are incredibly over time because I was spending too much time talking shit about Karen and Jinri. Now I just realized our studio has in fact closed. So we got to get the fuck out of here. Angelicopter, thanks for being here. Follow her on Twitter at TheAngelicopter. She is, it's nice to have you back, man.
Thank you. When you don't have Princess Nell or Georgina or Ellen on the show, then you can guest me anytime.
Okay. Well, you have to actually be in the same fucking city that I'm in at the time because I know you are traveling a good deal. But yeah, next time you're in town, let's get together and throw out another podcast out there, man. Yeah, man. You should think about doing one of your own, like some sort of laughing podcast. You just sit there and laugh with that obnoxious loud. What's that TV show with the maid?
Nanny? No, come on. That's
too it almost sounds
nothing's
like that.
Changed.
All right. Just saying. Let us get out of here. We got to go. Hey, caller of the night. Chopper, who do you want? Quick.
I want the guy that experimented with his sexuality.
Oh, is that James? Is that what his name? Is that what it was? James?
Yes.
James?
Yes, James. Hello? I love Hello. James.
James, the straight guy that only found out he was straight when there was a dick near his ass. All right, James. Congratulations. You're caller of the night. You can win yourself an iPad mini. We need you to pick 1, 2, or 3. One of those boxes has a iPad mini. The other ones have several other prizes that you can win, like watches and gift packs and whatnot. So choose well, my friend, and I hope you get it.
I hope you get it.
Number three.
All right. Oh,
yeah.
Because yesterday I said, please pick number three, everyone.
Then it's probably number two.
Yeah, it'll probably be number two or number one. Globe, what is it?
Globe Lifestyle.
Globe Tattoo Stick? Oh, man. It's okay. That's fine. You're good.
You're good.
Just don't put the tattoo stick in any places, you know what I mean. All right, where were we? Where was the iPad?
Number one.
All right. Thanks, James. Have a great night. We got to go. We'll see you guys next week. Have a great weekend.
All right.
This has been Good Times from Mo, the podcast season two, brought to you by Globe. Again, thank you, Angelicopter, for being here. Thank you, the staff, for doing such a great job this whole week. We want to say goodbye to one of our other interns, Gian. She has, is back to school now for some of our interns. So we do, tend to lose them this week. So we will miss you. Please come back. You'll always have a family with us. And, for the new batch of interns that will come around, it being school season, we look forward to seeing you guys on the program as well. All right, everyone. Goodbye. Take care. Later.
Good Times with Mo, the podcast, was executively produced by Mohan Gumata, engineered by Miguel Alfindel, and operated by Icon Media Inc.
Special thanks to Magic 89.9. You can follow Mo on Twitter at www.twitter.com/DJ Mo Twister.
Email him at goodtimeswithmopodcast@rocketmail.com.